This audio is going to disturb us a lot because we are all in a professional forum, and then where we are going to have our career advisor who is going to give us a lot of inputs about our program and then about the career that what you can pursue. So during the, if at all you have got any questions, you can keep on putting it on the chat section. Once the, we will be taking up each and every question to answer your doubts, and then we can clarify you with, we can clarify those doubts and then the questions along with the career advisor. Hagen Nene, you will have one more option there. Raise your hand anta one option idha nimma chat room alli. You can raise your hand indicating that neevu career advisor jothe maatadakke bayasthira anta heli. So you can definitely open up that, I mean you can press that and you can definitely go ahead with that. And once you raise your hand, we will come to know that you would like to speak to our career advisor. Eventually we are going to take it up. And I request everyone to maintain the decorum of the session. So there might be network issues. If at all you get disconnected for because of any of the network issues, please get reconnected back with the same ID on the with the same link, and then there will not be any chance to miss out any kind of important informations what you are going to get. Session shuru maduva modalu vidyarthigalalli vande ondu chikka manavi ittukolladakke kodtini. Ee karyakramavanna yashasvigalisalu nimmellara sahakara agatyagatya. Ee karyakrama nimigoskarane roopisirudu, hagagi nimmellara sahakara tumba atyagatya ide. ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಜೊತೆ ಮಾತಾಡೋಣಕ್ಕೆ ಒಂದು ಅವಕಾಶವನ್ನ ಕಲ್ಪಿಸಿಕೊಡ್ತೇವೆ. ಆದ್ರಿಂದ ಚಾಟ್ ರೂಮ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಆಗಿರಿ, ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಗಳಿಗೂ ಕೂಡ ನಾವು ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವನ್ನ ಶುರು ಮಾಡುವಂತ ಒಂದು ಸಮಯ ಬಂದಿದೆ. ಈಗ ನಾವೆಲ್ಲರೂ ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವನ್ನ ಶುರು ಮಾಡೋಣ. ಯಾ ವಿದ್ಯಾ ಸಾ ವಿಮುಕ್ತೆಯೇ, ಅವಿದ್ಯೆ ನಮ್ಮನ್ನ ಕತ್ತಲಿನ ಕೂಪಕ್ಕೆ ತಳ್ಳುತ್ತೆ, ಆದ್ರೆ ಸದ್ವಿದ್ಯೆ ನಮ್ಮನ್ನ ಬೆಳಕಿನತ್ತ ಕರೆದೊಯ್ಯುತ್ತದೆ. ಈ ಬೆಳಕಿನತ್ತ ಕರೆದೊಯ್ಯುವಂತಹ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವನ್ನ ಇವತ್ತು ಯಶಸ್ವಿಯಾಗಿ ನಿಮ್ಮೊಂದಿಗೆ ತರಲು ಶ್ರೀ ಸಾಯಿರಾಮ್ ಕಾಲೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನಗಳನ್ನ ಮಾಡಿದೆ. ಆ ಒಂದು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವನ್ನ ಯಶಸ್ವಿಯಾಗಿ ಮಾಡುವಂತೆ ನಾವೆಲ್ಲರೂ ನಿಮ್ಮನ್ನು ಕೋರಿಕೊಳ್ಳುತ್ತೇವೆ. ನೌ ಐ ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಅವರ್ ಬಿಲಾವೆಡ್ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಲ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಬಿ ಷಡಕ್ಷರಪ್ಪ ಸರ್ ಟು ಅಡ್ರೆಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಸಿಪೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು. ಓವರ್ ಟು ಯು ಸರ್.
Good morning, all. Myself, Dr. B. Shadaksharappa, Principal, Sri Sairam College of Engineering. Respected dignitaries on the panel, our management representative, Dr. R. Arun Kumar, our trustee, Sri K. Patel, sir, speaker of today's webinar, Sri Amin E. Mudha, sir, a renowned certified career advisor in Bangalore, heads of the department, faculties, principals of various PU colleges, parents, and my dear student participants. I welcome you all to this career guidance webinar on behalf of Sri Sairam College of Engineering family. Before I introduce today's speaker, I would like to present about my college. Our institute, Sri Sairam College of Engineering, formerly Shirdi Sai College of Engineering, established in the year 1997 by Melvin Jones Fellow Lion Leo Muthu, is the founder chairman of Saptagiri Educational and Charitable Trust. Our institute is accredited by National Assessment and Accreditation Council, that is NAAC, and Institution of Engineers of India. Our institute is also certified by ISO 9001:2015. Our institute is approved by AICT New Delhi and affiliated to Visveshwaraya Technological University. We are offering UG programs, four UG programs, BE in Computer Science and Engineering, BE in Electronics and Communication Engineering, BE in Electrical and Electronics Engineering, and BE in Mechanical Engineering. Also, we are running one research program in Mechanical Engineering program. When it comes to our institute, we are more focused on skill-based learning. To achieve this, we have established Innovation Center in the name of our founder chairman, Sri Leo Muthu Innovation Cell, and MHRD Innovation Cell, and MSME Business Incubation Center, and this has been supported by MHRD. And we have Visionary Learning Community of India, VLCI Center, to make students industry ready. And we are also having Institution Innovation, Entrepreneurship and Development Cell, IEDC Cell and ED Cell, supported by Department of Science and Technology and AICT. And also we have established a center for a center of excellence with respect to drone technology. So these we all established, all this we have established to bridge the gap between industry and academia, where we are focusing more on skill-based learning. And coming to our college salient features, we encourage merit students by giving a scholarship in the name of our founder chairman, that is Leo Muthu Scholarship. For merit students to encourage talent. And here, the scholarship is up to tuition waiver. Our college is ranked top 10 in Bangalore by reputed magazines. They conducted various surveys. Based on the surveys, they have rated our college is one of the top 10 college. Some of the reputed magazines they have ranked is DataQuest, Outlook, Educational World, Times of India, India Today, etc. And our institute continuously for the last few years, we are giving placement more than 95%. And coming to this corona lockdown, so our faculties and students are more effective in this period during this lockdown. Our faculties worked round the clock in preparing notes and lecturing videos and shared the materials through Google Classroom. Also taken online classes using various apps, effectively engaged and conducted online assessment tests also. Our management is provided digital tabs to all faculties to implementing these digital initiatives. And this was very helpful in this corona lockdown period. Our students, from Innovation Center through Leo Muthu Innovation Center, working on few projects to support the society to avoid the spread of coronavirus. So some of the projects they have done, almost they're completed. They are medical robot to assist in the hospitals, automated and voice controlled lift. So this particular software we are going to use in the lift. So without pressing the button, we are operating the lift. And currency sanitizer, sanitizing the currency notes and online retail marketing, traveler permission pass verification also. These are some of the projects they have done during this lockdown period by our innovation center. Also, we have donated 100 face shield masks made by our alumni students to local authorities. So this is about our activities of our Sairam College of Engineering. And now I would like to welcome our speaker of today's program, Amin E. Mudha sir. In this occasion, I would like to introduce our expert speaker. Amin E. Mudha sir is the founder and CEO Sigma, Career Information and Guidance Movement for All, India's leading career guidance and memory training organizations. He is an engineering graduate from PESIT, Bangalore, who worked with Emphasis India in 2004. He has visited 100 plus cities in India, UAE, Qatar, and Oman, and conducted 550 plus workshops and programs reaching out to more than 2 lakh plus students. He has appeared on popular Kannada news TV channels, Suvarna News, 24/7, Raj News, and Doordarshana, Chandana TV as a career expert for live career counseling for students. He's an expert speaker and panelist for media programs, The Hindu and Deccan Herald. He has written 50 plus articles on career and education for leading English regional newspapers, The Hindu, Deccan Herald, DNA, Daily Salar and Prajavani. He is also founder and head Career Yatra, E-Cubate and E-Scholar and South Indian NGO Conference. So this is about Mr. Amin E. Mudha sir, a renowned certified career advisor in Bangalore. And coming to this session, this webinar, this session will be very useful and beneficial to all of you. I request all of you kindly participate actively and make use of this program effectively And before I conclude, I want to say the message to all of you. Stay at home, stay safe, break the chain. Thank you. Now I request Malini to take over. Thank you.
We have started Sri Liyumuthu Innovation Center in the year 2015, basically to fill the gap between industry and academia. So the uniqueness of our Liyumuthu Innovation Center is interdisciplinary projects. So our students with all different disciplines, they are participating irrespective of the semester. Here all the students from first year to final year students are involved in doing various innovative projects. And later we are taking that process into a products and products into a patents. So from this innovation center, we have brought out a lot of innovative projects.
This innovation center, you know, coming and working here, it makes us, you know, it gives exposure to a lot of technologies that academics don't talk about, right? So in academics, we have a lot other stuff, and in the real world, everyday technology is evolving. So what happens is when we come here, we discover new things, new technologies, simpler ways to do things.
We had participated in Smart India Hackathon, which comes under the Government of India. Our project was basically was from the Ministry of Food Corporation of India. In which we had to digitize the entire system of the warehouse of entire India. We received first place and with a cash prize of 1 lakh rupees.
These are highly helpful for students, and it is a real motivation factor for the students to explore more and more and new things. I am really happy that our Liyumuthu Innovation Center is performing really well. We look forward to more students to get enrolled and more students to get benefit out of this. So these kind of activity will give a real impact for this education.
Come, be a part of a truly world-class learning experience at Sri Sai Ram College of Engineering.
Thank you, Reji sir. Thank you for that, AV. Thank you, everyone. This session in Kannada and English, it's going to be a mix. Because ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಡೆದಿರುವಂತಹ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳು ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಕಡೆಯಿಂದ ಬಂದವರಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಭಾಗದಿಂದ ಮತ್ತೆ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ರಾಜ್ಯಗಳಿಂದ ಕೂಡ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬೋತ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪೋಷಕರಲ್ಲಿ ಮತ್ತು ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ವಿನಂತಿ, ಈ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಮಾಹಿತಿಗಳನ್ನ ನಿಮಗೋಸ್ಕರನೇ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು. ಈ ಕಾಲೇಜಿನ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಇಡೀ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಓದುವಂತ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಮಕ್ಕಳುಗಳಿಗೆ ಕೂಡ ಉಪಯುಕ್ತವಾಗುವಂತ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಮಾಹಿತಿಯನ್ನ ನಾವು ನಿಮ್ಮೊಂದಿಗೆ ಹಂಚಿಕೊಳ್ಳಲಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಈಗ ನಮ್ಮೊಂದಿಗೆ ಇರಲು ನಮ್ಮ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಟು ಲಿಸನ್ ಟು ಅವರ್ ಟುಡೇಸ್ ಎಸ್ಟೀಮ್ಡ್ ಗೆಸ್ಟ್ ಶ್ರೀ, ಐ ಮೀನ್ ಈ ಮುದಸರ್ ಸರ್, ಅವರನ್ನು ಸ್ವಾಗತಿಸ್ತಾ ಓವರ್ ಟು ಯು ಸರ್. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.
Hello everybody, and a very good morning to this career webinar. I'm extremely okay, one second, let me do the settings. Okay, so for all the students, for all the parents, ellarigu good morning, matte namaskara and salams. I'm sure most of you have given your 12th exams and PUC exam kotmele nimge you are you're actually excited to join your degree. And along with the excitement, you're also feeling that pain that during the lockdown, you are quite stuck. You are quite confused ki what will happen in the next few months. So first thing I would like to set straight, ellarigu yenandre, this is the best opportunity you have got to make your career something different. ಈ ಲಾಕ್ಡೌನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಲೈಫ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಷ್ಟು ಸಮಯ ಯಾರಿಗೂ ಸಿಗಲ್ಲ. ಇಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಸಮಯ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿದ್ರೆ ಆ ಸಮಯದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಎಷ್ಟು ನಮ್ಮ ಒಳಗಡೆ ನೋಡ್ಕೋತೀವಿ, ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೋರ್ ಅವರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ನೆವರ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಎವರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮಚ್ ಟೈಮ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ಡು ನಾಟ್ ನೋ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ವೆನ್ ದಿ ಲಾಕ್ಡೌನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಎಂಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವೆನ್ ದಿ ಆಕ್ಚುಯಲ್ ಅಡ್ಮಿಷನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಗಿನ್, ಬಟ್ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದಿಸ್ ವೆಬಿನಾರ್ I am sure that most of you would like to, you know, explore more about what you can do in life. So let me begin today's presentation, which is after 12th what next. And I should thank at this outset the Sri Sairam College of Engineering, their management, for taking this opportunity of bringing out this awareness for the students. And in these tough times, this webinar is definitely a great initiative. So thank you so much for the management of Sri Sairam College of Engineering. About me, it's been told, just want to add one thing, that I got into engineering, but I am a qualified engineer and now a practicing career counselor. The reason I'm telling this is because the only reason why I'm here is because I stood out from the crowd. So it's a journey of finding your passion. It's a journey of accepting that you really are good at something. And it's a journey of going through a real, real tough time. And then finally you get rewarded over a period of time. So let's go into the presentation. So this is the scenario which most of you will be facing. You will all be facing, you know, you will all have, you are not still excited, but once the results are going to come, everything is going to be in place, and you will actually feel that your exams and your results are going to be out. But you will celebrate. You will celebrate whatever comes to you. But does everything end there? No. So today, it's a very different scene. Many years ago, we used to have one person who used to be the state topper, but now we have so many people who are state toppers. We have so many people who are state toppers, and this is the scenario that you all are seeing. Today, scoring 99% is so easy that we find many of them actually scoring these results, and they are seen as the toppers. So that's the difference that we find now in the results. But let me add you one thing, that in life, all victories don't come early. Okay. On the left side, what you see is a girl last year who scored the first rank in CBSE by scoring 499 on 500. While you are also seeing on the right side, the UPSC topper of last year who scored just 60% in his 10th standard and 67% in 12th standard. And his engineering, he finished 71%. But he stood third for the entire country, and he is today an IAS officer. So friends, life is all about playing the game at your pace. And when you get the best opportunity, go for the sixes. Okay. So some of you would have scored less in 10th, or may happen to score less in your 12th, but don't worry. Life is all about how you can come back and fight. And that's why it's popularly called in Hindi, haar kar jeetne wale ko baazigar kehte hain. Okay. So don't worry. You may get less marks. You may get less ranking. You may not get exactly what you wanted, but you are definitely going to win the race as long as you believe that you have the potential. Okay. I hope most of you have seen this movie, and this movie is one of the most iconic movies of our times, in which Aamir Khan plays a very great role. And he talks about how khabil bano. I mean, you need to develop a capacity in you. You need to develop certain things which will stand out for you. You need to be the person who is going to be having so much of potential that nobody should deny you a job. Okay. So kamyabi jhak maar ke piche aayegi. And for that, you need to be having the capacity. You need to build the capacity in you. And once you do that, you are definitely going to have a lot of options coming forward for you. So get motivated by all these clippings that you see here and there. So normal parents, you know, they ask a question. Ivaga ee karyakramadalli parents kuda idare. Samanyavagi parents yen keltare, yen aagbekanta idiyappa, what do you want to become? And that question itself is a problem. Nan prakara aa prashne bere irbeku. The question should be, what all do you want to become? Friends, this life that we have got is a one time opportunity for all of us. We all have one time opportunity, and in this one time opportunity, we can actually, you know, be into multiple roles. We can be into multiple roles. We can do multiple jobs. All we need to do is plan our careers effectively. So today I put a question to all of you. Please ask yourself today at the end of the seminar, what all do you want to become? What all do you want to become? Okay. I'm sure all of you had multiple dreams. You wanted to become a chef. You wanted to become a doctor. You wanted to be a pilot. You wanted to be a nurse. But somewhere you also started feeling that, no, what will people tell? People will always tell. What you need to be clear is what you will do and what you will love to do again and again. So parents, ye vantu prashne andre, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ದಯವಿಟ್ಟು ಏನ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ಬೇಡಿ. ನೀನ್ ಏನೇನ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕಂತ ಇದೀ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿ. ಅದರಿಂದ ಅವ್ರ ಮನಸ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಆಸೆಗಳಿದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಅದಕ್ಕೆಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು ಅವಕಾಶ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ. ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಗ್ರೇಟ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಕರಿಯರ್? ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಕರಿಯರ್? ಕರಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಡಿಸೈರ್. ಓವರ್ ಎ ಪೀರಿಯಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಒಂದು ಆಸೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಕರಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಲರ್ನಿಂಗ್, ಅನ್ಲರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರೀಲರ್ನಿಂಗ್. Please remember that when you finish your PUC, when you finish your degree, when you go forward, you will have to learn a lot of new things. You may have to unlearn things. Okay. And then you may have to relearn things. The path we choose to change the world we live in. It is the path we choose to change the world we live in. It's a destination. It is a calling. Okay. You all feel that, yes, I want to become a CA. Yes, I want to become an aerospace engineer. Yes, I want to become the best computer science engineer in the world. It's a calling. And career means you get married to certain things. You get married to certain culture. You get married to certain values. You get married to certain timings of work, right? And a career is about your identity. It's your identity. It's about you, what you want to become, and how you want to become. Okay. So the idea is you have to ensure that you are going to be there and you are going to stand out there. And at the last, the most important thing is you should be able to tell that all is well. If you are able to tell that all is well, what happens is you believe that you have taken the right decisions. So career is not just getting a job. Career is not just landing up into some country. Career is not just, you know, getting highly paid. It's a process of all these things. Please remember that as long as you believe that you are born and you want to work hard with those inborn abilities, you are going to make a huge difference for your life. Let's move forward. So great career, a real career makes you a leader. Look beyond the horizon. You need to look at, you know, options where you can be the person who is seen up. I always give the example of Dr. Devi Shetty. What if Dr. Devi Shetty was not a doctor? The world would have lost a great person who would have otherwise, you know, been doing something else. So Dr. Devi Shetty avaru ondu cardiac surgeon agi adrallo speciality agi avaru ondu ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಕಾರ್ಡಿಯಾಕ್ ಸರ್ಜನ್ ಆಗಿ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಫೆನಾಮಿನಲ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ನೋಬಡಿ ಕುಡ್ ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್. ಸೊ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಕರಿಯರ್ ಮೇಕ್ಸ್ ಯು ಎ ಲೀಡರ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಶ್ಯೂರ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಬಿಕಮ್ ಲೀಡರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಕರಿಯರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಹೌ ಡು ಯು ಚೂಸ್ ಅ ಕರಿಯರ್? ಮೆನಿ ಆಫ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ಲೈಕ್ ವೈ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅ ಕರಿಯರ್? ಓಕೆ, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ವೈ ಶುಡ್ ಐ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್? ವೈ ಶುಡ್ ಐ ನಾಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್? ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ನೋ ದಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಯುನೀಕ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ನೋ ಮೈ ಯುನೀಕ್ನೆಸ್. ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ವರ್ಕ್ ಫಾರ್ 40+ years. You will have to work for 80,000 hours in your life. And I'm sure most of you wish that every day should have been like a holiday. And in this holiday, you want to make more money. You want to live with freedom. You have a vision, okay? And please remember, you have born only once, and one day it will be RIP, rest in peace, right? just yesterday we saw the death of one of India's finest actors, Irfan Khan. So he was just 53, but what he has left behind is a legacy of acting for all the people who are going to enter into the theater industry or the film industry. He will be shown as a class apart actor because he left that mark. And last but not the least, my dear friends, you all have to select your career because you want to be remembered for. Please ask this question again and again. What do I want to be remembered for? What do I want to be remembered for? And that question can actually make a lot of difference for you. So this is why you need to select your career. Now, when you talk about career selection, there are four things which play a very important role. Number one is your aptitude. Aptitude is your inner ability. Most of us get our aptitude through our genes, through our parents, okay? And aptitude is final by the age of 14. By 14, all our aptitudes are finalized according to psychology. Second thing is personality. Personality is the unique qualities we have. Why do we laugh? Why don't we cry? Why do we shout? Why are we so interested in somebody? These are all personality traits. The third thing comes into picture is skills. See, today, if you are skilled, you are built. Let me explain here. If you are skilled means you have a particular skill, like you have a skill of analyzing, you have a skill of speaking, you have a skill of doing certain things efficiently, and hence you are built. You are built means you are paid accordingly. Most of you aspire to have high salary jobs. You all want a salary of 50,000 per month, 1 lakh per month. These are great dreams, but dreams cannot be built just because you are dreaming. They are built because you have the ability, you have the personality, you have the skills. And lastly, all these things will tell you that, yes, this is my interest. So here, the clarification I wish to give to all of you is, all of you love to do something. ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಆಸೆ ಇದೆ, ನಾನು ನಾನು ಪೈಲಟ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು, ನಾನು ಐ ಎ ಎಸ್ ಆಫೀಸರ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು, ನಾನು ಒಂದು ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು. ಆ ಆಸೆ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ, ಆ ಆಸೆನ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ನೀವು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಎಬಿಲಿಟಿ, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಪರ್ಸನಾಲಿಟಿ, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ಸ್ ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ನೀವು ನೋಡಿ, ಆಮೇಲೆ ನೀವು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಆಸೆ ಮೇಲೆ ನೀವು ಅದರ ಮೇಲೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಆಸೆನ ಇಡಿ. ಲೈಕ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್, ಇಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಎಬಿಲಿಟಿ, ಇಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಪರ್ಸನಾಲಿಟಿ, ಅಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್, ವಿ ಕೌನ್ಸಿಲರ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಲೆಸ್ ಚಾಲೆಂಜಿಂಗ್ ಕರಿಯರ್. ಲೆಸ್ ಚಾಲೆಂಜಿಂಗ್ ಕರಿಯರ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಸ್ಮೂತ್ ಆಗಿ ಸೇಲ್ ಆಗ್ತೀರಾ, ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸ್ವಿಮ್ ವೆರಿ ನೈಸ್ಲಿ ವಿತೌಟ್ ಎನಿ ಟ್ರಬಲ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಮ್ ಏನಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಇವಾಗ, ಇವಾಗ ಲಾಕ್ಡೌನ್ ಆಗಿದೆ, ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಹೌ ದ ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕರಿಯರ್ಸ್. ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್, ಪೀಪಲ್ ಹು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬೀನ್ ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದರ್ ಎಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೋಸ್ ಹು ಆರ್ ಸಸ್ಟೈನಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್, ನೀವು ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪಿ ಯು ಸಿ ಆದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಜಾಯಿನಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಕರಿಯರ್, ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ವೆರಿ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಆಪ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಡ್, ಯುವರ್ ಪರ್ಸನಾಲಿಟಿ, ಯುವರ್ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಯುವರ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್. ಈ ಮೂರು ಎ ಪಿ ಎಸ್ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ, ಇದು ಮೂರು ಕಣ್ಣಿಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಆಮೇಲೆ ಎಸ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಲವ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಅಂತ ಹಾಕಿ, ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಎ ಜೆನ್ಯೂನ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್. ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್ ಮೆನಿ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ನಾನು ಹುಡುಗರು ಕೇಳ್ತೀನಿ, ಏನಪ್ಪ ಏನಾಗ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ, ಸರ್ ನಾನು ಪೈಲಟ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕು. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ, ನೀನು ಏರ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಪೈಲಟ್ ಆಗ್ತೀಯಾ ಇಲ್ಲಿಯಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಏರ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಪೈಲಟ್ ಆಗ್ತೀಯಾ ಅಂತ. ಅವಾಗ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಸರ್ ಏನೂ ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ನಾನು ಕುತ್ಕೋಬೇಕು, ನಾನು ಏರ್ ಕ್ರಾಫ್ಟ್ ನ ಟೇಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಸರ್. ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಬಿಗ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ ಏರ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಏರ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಬಿ ವೆರಿ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಆಪ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಡ್, ಪರ್ಸನಾಲಿಟಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಹೌ ಡು ಯು ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅ ಕರಿಯರ್? ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಇನ್ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಕರಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ಯು ನೀಡ್ ಟು you need to know yourself. You need to know yourself, who you are, what you are, okay? And that's a journey that will take time. The second thing is you need to explore career options. You need to explore all the options available for you, which you will be doing it today. The third thing is you should take a decision. Like, you need to have plan A, B, C, D. Four options, okay? So never decide on only one option, because deciding on one option will always put you at a high risk. You will then have total loss of decision making, and you may jump into waters which you have never understood or never realized them. Then we have got taking action, implementing the career plan. Now this is where most of them actually lose. ಒಂದು ಕರಿಯರ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ಫುಲ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಗೋಲ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಗೋಲ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಲಾಂಗ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಗೋಲ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಆ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಗೋಲ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಗೋಲ್ನ ಕಂಬೈನ್ ಅದನ್ನ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಮುಂದೆ ಹೋದ್ರೆ it is actually implementing your career plan. So how do you select a career? You select a career by knowing yourself, exploring all the options, taking a decision, putting the plan A, B, C, D, and taking action. Let's move forward. So how do you know about yourself? I just list out everything on the screen so that I may touch upon the most important parts. The first thing is make time to question yourself and be tough and honest. Okay. Find out what interests you genuinely by looking into your past achievements. Like when I was in school, I was genuinely interested in people. I did not have interest in technology, but I still managed to do engineering, and then from engineering moved to humanities because finally the genuine interest came out after a period of time. Know more about yourself from your parents and friends. Don't just know about the good things, but also know about the challenging things that you have. Okay, get nostalgic, go back to school days, recall what you really, really enjoyed. The next thing is explore careers. So when you are exploring careers, there's a lot of information there. Okay, list out all the careers you know. So today, after the webinar, if you could sit down and list every career option that you know, every option that you know, okay, visit the job websites, Naukri.com, Monster.com, you will get to know more. Read the education supplements in newspapers. Visit institutes, colleges, and universities. Now, you had a very good introduction about the Sairam College of Engineering. They showed their video. They showed you the Innovation Center. The best thing would be that when the lockdown is over and when you are free, please visit this college and see how actually engineering college works, how the labs are set up. What is the meaning of Innovation Center? Because sitting at home, you will actually not have the complete idea about how an engineering college or a medical college or a pharmacy college or even a basic science college is. So please visit the institutions. Do not take a decision without visiting the institution. I have seen many students by hearsay, they know about institutions, they don't visit. And then they say, I was informed about this by my friend. Remember, this is your career and you need to be responsible. Meet professionals, students, and freshers in that career. If you are trying to get into mechanical engineering, don't join mechanical engineering because you love machines. Everybody loves machines. You are liking a machine. I am liking a machine. So we are using a machine. The point is you need to meet people who are into the mechanical industry and know more about them. Meet people who are studying that branch of engineering. If you have doubts about electrical engineering, if you have doubts about aeronautical engineering, please meet students. Meet fresh graduates who are actually in search of job. They will tell you more realities. Of course, meet career counselors. I am a career counselor and you can meet me anytime. Read career guidance books or print online. Prepare a list of careers you wish to pursue. Your wish list is your wish list. Please do not have a limitation. Wish everything. When I was in 7th, I wanted to become Shah Rukh Khan because I saw Bazigar. When I was in 9th, I wanted to become Deve Gowda Ji because he was the prime minister when I was in 9th. I wanted to become the prime minister of India. When I was in 12th, I wanted to become the best electronics engineer. When I went to engineering, I realized I will never be a great engineer. I wanted to become a career counselor, right? So things change a lot for you when you explore. The third point is decision making. So have the list of careers and your criteria ready. Like you have a full list of careers that you love to pursue and what you are looking for. Now find out which career suits your criteria. Nange en beko nange yav reethi lifestyle beko nan yav reethi nanna pratidina belts beko, how should I do it? These are all things which come under your criteria. So drill down to 3 to 5 career options for which you have the aptitude, personality, and interest. Find out more about these options with your parents and friends. Meet career counselors for any help. Okay, clarify all doubts, even a small doubt. Sir, ee career dalli eshtu gante kelsa madbeku? Sir, in this career, will I be paid on a monthly basis or contract basis? Sir, in this, do I have the option to go to Australia, Singapore, America? Sir, can I start my own business? Sir, will it take a lot of hard work in this career? No question is silly, but ask it because tomorrow when you end up in a career, you should not blame yourself that I made a mistake. So be very, very careful. Then decide. Okay, take a decision that this will be my plan A, plan B, and plan C. And finally, believe in yourself. Your belief system is very, very important. Remember, it is you who has to stand with the decisions you make. Everybody else will help you, guide you, make you feel comfortable, but whatever decisions you take, you are responsible for that. So be very clear about the decision. Lastly, how do you do decision making? Decision making is possible by starting action. There are 5 P's. Proper planning prevents poor performance. Follow this. Prepare short-term and long-term plans. Short-term plan is what you are going to do in the next 3-4 years. Long-term plan is what you are going to do in the next 10-20 years. Short-term plan is which are the courses you are going to do in this lockdown. Long-term plan is what are all the options available for you to do in the next 3-4 months. So contextually, there will be short-term and long-term plans. Fix deadlines. Make a list of things to do. Stick to your plan, but refine it along the way if necessary. ತುಂಬ ಜನರಿಗೆ ಆಸೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ನಾನು ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕು, ನಾನು ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಸರ್ಜನೇ ಆಗ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂತ. ಆದರೆ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸೇ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿಯಿಂಗ್ ವೆಲ್, ಪುಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಎಫರ್ಟ್ಸ್, ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಮೆಡಿಕಲ್ ಸೀಟ್ ಸಿಗಲ್ಲ. ಅವಾಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ನಾನು ಡಾಕ್ಟ್ರೇ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕು, ಇಲ್ಲ ಇವಾಗ ನನಗೆ ನೀಟ್ ಪರ್ಫಾರ್ಮೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ, ನನಗೆ ನೀಟ್ ರ್ಯಾಂಕಿಂಗ್ ಕಡೆ ಬಂದಿದೆ, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡೂ ಮೆಡಿಸನ್, ಫರ್ಗೆಟ್ ಮೆಡಿಸನ್, ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಡೂ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್. ಈ ತರ ಡಿಸಿಷನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಬಾರ್ದು. ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಟರ್ನೇಟಿವ್ಸ್ ಟು MBBS, ವಿಚ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಟುಡೇ. ಸೊ ರಿಫೈನ್ ದಟ್. Your aim should not be to become a specialist doctor. Your aim should be, I want to be a person who will save people's lives. See, today, if people are saving lives in this lockdown, it is not just doctors. There are nurses, there are paramedics, there are people who are working at the emergency units. So let's look at the larger picture of a career and then refine it. Have plan A, plan B, plan C, plan D. And let's be very clear that what is plan D is also plan A. Means you will be having the same happiness by choosing plan D, even if you don't get A, B or C. So A, B, C, D don't mean 1, 2, 3, 4 in the order. It means I'm perfectly fine with A or B or C or D, right? You are happy with all the options. Be happy to get any plan. Okay, so that is why the decision making is so important and taking action is the next step. Make the best efforts you can and leave the rest to God. So let's not, you know, take the results in our hands. Our job is effort. What we should do, naven madbekandre nam kadeyinda nam hastra eshtu options ide aa ella options na munde itkondo ond olle decision takondo a b c d option itkondre we will be very very comfortable when we are taking admission for the courses and colleges. So this is my favorite slide in my presentation. Career planning is all about finding the sweet spot. Friends, if you see here, there's the green circle. The green circle is stuff you love to do. This blue circle, the dark blue circle, is stuff you are good at. You love to do something, you are good at something, and the third most important thing is stuff someone will pay you to do. This is what you need to look at. You like to do something, you are good at it. This is the most important combination. And the third thing is someone is ready to pay you for that. And that is where people get paid highly. What is the reason that some people are paid very high in their job is because they love what they're doing. They love what they're doing. They are good at it. And lastly, they will get paid because they are really doing it well. So remember, you have to love what you do and you have to be good at what you love to do. And then find the person who will pay you for what you are doing and you will always have a smile on your face. Okay. Now let's dream big. There are more than 25,000 plus career across the globe. Live your life. Don't have small options. Don't think small. Don't think that one course maadkottini job sikbidutte illa irthini. I'm sure there are many people here from outside Bangalore also. I saw the poll, right? So please remember that this world is one family. We are all in one family. The borders are gone. If you see social media, you sit here and you tweet, it can reach somebody in some corner of the world. So dream big. Let your dreams be big. Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, the former president of India, told, small dream is a crime. So let me tell you, don't do the crime of dreaming small. Dream big. You have the greatest opportunities. We are going through a pandemic. We are going through the worst of the worst situations, but your dreams should not be shattered because of this. Please dream big. It's a great opportunity for you waiting. So sit back, but don't relax as we take off to discover a lot of careers now. Let me start with careers in medicine. We'll start with careers in medicine. And most of you are aspiring to pursue a career in medicine. if you want to excel in medicine, right, you need to have proven academic skills. You need to be like that Chatur Ramalingam in Three Idiots, right? He is a pakka academic guy who used to have a lot of mug up stuff done. You need to have a larger hard disk. You need to be a test match player. Perseverance will be very, very tested in medicine. And most importantly, you need to have empathy. Empathy is service to humanity. But after medicine, after doing your 5-year medicine course, if you want to go to post-graduation, there are two things which play an important role. Number one, out-of-the-box brains. Because the competition level after your MBBS for your MD and further super specialty is going to be steep. It's not going to be like how you study biology or chemistry very well for NEET and crack and get into a medical college. The path after your MBBS, MBBS aadmele MD madakke nimage two options irutte. Ondo neevu sikkapatte odbeko, you should have out of the box brain, illa andre very rich parents. Okay. The next thing is, does MBBS make you a doctor? Does only MBBS make you a doctor? No. Today, if you want to become a doctor, there are options which are beyond MBBS also. We have MBBS. We have so many more options. Let's look at all these options, okay? So MBBS is a 5-year medical course. At the end of doing MBBS, what happens is you actually get a degree. You are licensed. You get the license to give a injection, okay? You get the license to treat people. You can open your clinic. And the best part of doing MBBS is you can be self-employed from day one. You don't have to, you know, go and work at other locations. You don't have to go and, you know, work. Why do people go and work with hospitals, nursing homes? Is because you want to see more number of patients, because a doctor's experience is only by seeing more number of patients. So MBBS is the most popular option in this country. At the same time, MBBS is also the one of the toughest courses to get in. So if you do well in your NEET exam, and if you do well, and if you get a ranking which will help you to get admission into the government quota seats, fair enough. Otherwise, you will have to end up in a private quota seats, which is another big topic to discuss. So at this point, what I would like to say is, you will become a doctor if you do MBBS, and further specialty, super specialty becomes very much a need, because most of the MBBS graduates, they feel the need that if you don't do specialty and super specialty, you are not going to be recognized. Okay. But unfortunately, there's increasing demand that a lot of people want to have a family physician, and most of the family physicians will be people with MBBS qualification. Now, coming to the alternates available with us. We have got homeopathy, BHMS. We have got BAMS, Ayurveda. We have got BUMS. Then we have got BDS. We have got veterinary science. And we have got bachelor's in physiotherapy. So homeopathy is based out of Germany. It started in Germany. Ayurveda is Indian based. Unani is the Islamic medicine, the prophetic medicine. Then we have got the dental sciences. Then we have got veterinary science. And if you become a veterinary science, vet, you do BBSC and animal husbandry, bachelor's in veterinary science and animal husbandry, you become a doctor for crocodiles, and imagine, they will always cooperate with you. Okay, unlike human beings who will ask you so many questions, these people will always cooperate with you. They would love to, you know, they would love to be treated. The last option is an option which is not popular, but I would like to express here, is physiotherapy. Physiotherapy is a 4-year course, and in this course, you learn how to help patients come out of long-term. These patients are referred by orthopedics. You know, a patient with an ortho problem will go and will get cured or get operated through a surgery, and then he needs to go through a rehabilitation. This is done by a physiotherapist. So if you finish BPT, you can call yourself a doctor. Like, you can call yourself Dr. Amin Mudassar. But after that, you need to mention that as BPT, like physiotherapist, right? So this is another option that you can work into. To talk about BHMS, BAMS, BUMS, BMYS, all these will help you to become a doctor and treat patients. And remember, dental health is only going to be limited to the mouth, neck, and ear. That's the limitation of doing BDS. we looked into some of the health options, health courses. So after second PUC, the Karnataka Paramedical Board conducts several courses. Medical lab, medical x-ray, dialysis technology, operation theater, dental hygiene, dental mechanic. These are all two-year courses. ಇದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪಿ ಯು ಸಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪಾಸ್ ಆಗಿರಬೇಕು ನೀವು ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ವೆಬ್ಸೈಟ್ tmbkarnataka.org ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗಿ ನೀವು ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು ಒನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಅಪ್ಲೈ ದೇರ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ಅಡ್ಮಿಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಟೂ ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಎ ಟೆಕ್ನಿಷಿಯನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಬಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನದರ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಚೂಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಡ್ವಾನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ಇಯರ್ ಬಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಾಟ್ BSc Anesthesia Technology, BSc Medical Lab, BSc Imaging Technology, Perfusion Technology, right? So, these are all options. Cardiac Care Technology, Operation Theater Technology. These are all options, courses offered by Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Sciences. So, idr bagge nimage admission yavaga agutte ee varsha because the admission is delayed. Samanyavagi the admission for this begins in the month of May end or June. So, you can actually get admitted to these courses through Rajiv Gandhi University. Anesthesia, Medical Lab, Imaging. Idralli one of the most high paying courses is Cardiac Care Technology because today heart problems, hospitals which deal with heart problems are increasing. The number of ICU beds in heart hospitals has increased because the people who are coming with heart diseases is increasing. So, when you are a cardiac care technician, neven martira neevu hospital alli, especially heart hospital alli, you are going to take care of patients who have undergone a surgery. Avarge surgery agirutte, avarge monitor madbeku, avarge ondu bypass surgery agirabodu illa bere yeno surgery agirabodu heart alli, they will be admitted in the ICU for a couple of days. So cardiac care technicians work only with heart related problems patients. And that is a very high paying job. I know many students whom I have counseled over the years. They have worked in India or India dalli ondu 5 varsha kelsa maadi. Now they are settled in very high paying jobs in abroad. Okay, so that is a wonderful option. You can explore that. Matte less traveled path. I have a request here. The other host, if you can manage the admission of participants, it will be really great. A small request to the other host in here. The less traveled path, we have the less traveled path here, that is bachelor's in occupational therapy, bachelor's in rehabilitation therapy, then bachelor's in prosthetics and orthotics, bachelor's in public health, bachelor's in audio and speech language therapy. So I would see these as careers which have a lot of scope because they give you the freedom to start your own therapy center. Occupational therapy is a high demand therapy course. For example, an occupational therapist may charge for 1 hour nothing less than 500 to 1000 rupees. And I forgot to mention that even a physiotherapist would charge nothing less than 500 rupees for one session, which would last about 30 minutes. Good physiotherapists today make more money than people in other careers, which we think are making more money. So bachelor's in prosthetics and orthotics, public health, speech and audiology is a very great career. Let's see the courses in pharma. In pharmacy, we have got D pharma 2 years. We have got B pharma for 4 years. We have got Pharm D for 6 years. Okay. So the admission for this is through Karnataka CET for students from Karnataka. You will have to give the Karnataka CET exam if you want the quota, if you want to avail the benefits of a government course. Coming next is careers in nursing. In nursing, we have got a diploma of 2 years, then diploma of 3 years, ANMS auxiliary nursing and midwifery, GNMS general nursing and midwifery, and then we have got BSc nursing for 4 years. Here, I would highly recommend boys who want to become doctors but couldn't become doctors for several reasons, but want to be always working with patients, do pursue a career in BSc nursing because nursing is something which I feel is a very high-paying job, especially now the healthcare industry is going to boom for the next 5-10 years. There's going to be a huge demand for qualified nurses because there is going to be emphasis on nursing, and always nursing has been a high paid job, if not in India but in other countries. Good qualified nurses with experience of 3 to 5 years or more than that, they get paid very well with a 6-figure salary. So there's no entrance exam for this. The counseling is done through through the respective boards. Let's see some of the integrated courses here in science. Okay, we have a four-year teaching course now. We have got a four-year teaching course. The government has started a new B.Ed. course from this year, which will be for 4 years. 4 years B.Sc. B.Ed., then 4 years B.A. B.Ed. Then we also have the Bachelor of Science offered by IISc, which is in Bangalore. Then we have got Integrated Law course, which is a 5-year course, B.A. LLB, B.B.A. LLB, B.Com. LLB. Then we have got Integrated M.A. Developmental Studies course, which is 5 years from IIT Madras. We also have the only IIM in India which offers MBA after second PUC, 5-year MBA course is IIM Indore. I think from this year, even IIM Rohtak is also starting this course. And then we have got integrated MSc programs, which is 5-year applied physics, applied mathematics. Then pharma course, I did mention about this in the last slide. Then the integrated MTech course are also available, 6 years. Computer science, life sciences, earth sciences. So this was just to show you that after second PUC science, you have these sort of integrated programs also, which have a huge scope. So we come to engineering as a career now. Engineering is a very popular option. There are so many colleges now. There are hundreds of colleges. There are many, many branches available. But let me clarify a few things about engineering. Why should you take engineering and what qualities you should have if you want to excel in engineering? See, joining a course is different. Excelling in the course is another level. You need to have mathematical skills. You need to be good with basic maths. You don't have to be Ramanujam. You don't have to be, you know, somebody who will get 100 on 100. Somebody who can score easily above 75, 80 in maths is fairly good enough for engineering. Then communication skills. You need to have skills to put forward ideas, because as an engineer today, jobs are more about how do you communicate. Like now, we are using Zoom to communicate. We are do a webinar today. Almost 99% of IT companies are running on Zoom, and most of them are going to be tested on their communication skills. Communication skill is not just speaking what comes to your mind. It's ensuring that the person in front of you is knowing what you're speaking, is understanding, and you are able to get the correct feedback. The third thing is leadership. I always tell this small joke to my participants. No matter which course you join, okay, no matter which engineering college you join, this is something which I love to say, okay. Within 1 year, the principal of your college, okay, should know you for some reason or the other, good, bad, great, okay. He should know you. That is what is required when you go into graduation. Graduation is not the time for you to go and sit in the classroom in a corner and try to make some notes. It's the time that you make your presence felt. It is a time that you show that you are ready for the market. Engineering definitely requires a technical bent of mind. Whatever branch you choose, you need to be technically sound in that particular branch. Then problem solving. Engineers solve problems. You should have that flair. I am a problem solver. I am going to take every challenge. So no matter which engineering you take, your problem solving ability is going to be tested for everything that you pursue, for a job, for your further competitive exams. So try to solve problems. Try to be a problem solver. Okay. Here are the most popular engineering options. Students, you know, try to choose these options. That is electronics and communication. I have put three branches. All of these are popular. Okay. There is no hierarchy here. For the sake of, you know, making the color combination, I have just put here. We have got the green color. The green color indicates these careers as all the three branches of engineering lead you to one big world called IT. So graduates of EC, graduates of computer science, graduates of information science will be eligible for all the IT jobs. They will be eligible for all the IT jobs at once. So if you really want to get into IT, if you want to get an IT job, then you can choose any of these three branches: electronics, computers, and information science. So I'm very clear. As a student, I'm very clear that I want to get an IT job. I want to be in the IT industry. Now, IT industry has grown beyond imagination. The number of expertise, the number of specializations in IT is so huge that it will take a lot of time for people to understand, because the technology, especially after artificial intelligence and BI, everything has changed. A lot of things are happening. Now here, this electronics and communication, computer science and information science, I see as the options which are going to give you a lucrative career in IT. Okay. Then comes telecommunication, instrumentation, mechanical, civil, and electrical. Now, talking about each of these options, they are all interlinked. Like, for example, electrical sciences. Electrical science is a branch which covers computer science, electronics, as well as electrical science. Okay. It has all the three aspects. It is called the mother branch. If you look into the IITs, all the older IITs, the most in-demand course in all the IITs, the older ones, is electrical sciences, because electrical science has been the mother branch from which everything else started. It's not just about generating power and transmitting power. It has moved on to provide solutions to various industries, because today you see how electric cars are being manufactured to control the oxygen CO2 levels. So electrical science, be it mechanical, I feel, in my personal opinion, the green and the black ones are the ones which are having a stable option for you. Now, why did I put aeronautical and biotechnology in red color? Unfortunately, the boom for aeronautical and biotechnology could not last much in our country. Due to various reasons, the boom could not last. And most of the graduates of aeronautical and biotechnology today have left engineering and they're doing other jobs, like they pursued MBA and they totally forgot about that branch of engineering. So I would caution everybody, please don't go by the name. You know, many students tell me, sir, I love biology. I didn't become a doctor. So I love biology. I love technology. So I want to do biotechnology. Please don't do biotechnology with your life. Okay. So don't get into things which are just superficial. Explore the career in the right way, in the right method. Next, these are the options which are less traveled. These are high paying careers, but they are less popular. These are all engineering branches: agriculture, mining, road transport, petroleum, environment, railways, leather, ceramic, shipping, carpet, marine. The only challenge with these careers is the opportunities will be less. The opportunities will be less. When I say less, contextually, situationally, they will be less. Okay. And hence, the demand is more. Since the demand is more, the pay is more. For example, a marine engineer, a fresh marine graduate, is going to get a job of nothing less than 1 lakh per month. But the catch here is, as a marine engineer, you will not be working on the land. You will be going away into deep seas. You may not have communication with your family for 1 month, 1.5 months, but they will pay you nicely. So every high paying job comes with many, many challenges and risks. Today, when we see a software engineer who says, my monthly salary is 1 lakh, please remember that his boss is making him work for 14 hours to 16 hours a day. Let's be very clear. ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ನಮ್ಮ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಒಂದು ಆಸೆ ಇದೆ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ, ನಮ್ಮ ಮಗ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅವನಿಗೆ ತಿಂಗಳಿಗೆ 1 ಲಕ್ಷ ಸ್ಯಾಲ್ರಿ ಬೇಕು. ದಯವಿಟ್ಟು ಮನಸ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, 1 ಲಕ್ಷ ಸ್ಯಾಲ್ರಿ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅವ್ರು ನಿಮ್ಮಿಂದ 3 ಲಕ್ಷ ಕೆಲಸ ತೆಗಿಬೇಕು. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೌ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ವರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಇನ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ದ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಇಸ್ 1:3. ಇಫ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಪೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಸಂಬಡಿ 10,000 rupees, ಐ ಶುಡ್ ಎನ್ಶೋರ್ ದಟ್ 30,000 rupees ವರ್ಕ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಹಿಮ್. So please remember, joining engineering is not enough. Ali, join admele, you have to excel. You have to show excellence in that. So I'm just trying to put a brief list here. Okay, this is based on a couple of surveys done. This may not be the only best engineering branch list, but electrical, computer science, civil, mechanical, electronics, chemical, aerospace. These have somehow managed to be in the top engineering branches in this country. Nam country alli, these have been the most popular engineering branches. Okay, these are all equal. Like, electrical is not number one, computer science is not number two, or like that. All are equal. All of them have the popularity because of the stability they give you in engineering. Moving forward, we'll come to architecture. Now, in architecture, most of you know that there's an exam called NATA. Architecture join agbekandre, you have to give a test called NATA. If you don't give that NATA test, you can't take up architecture, whether it is government seat or it is a management quota seat. So we have got careers in architecture. That is, we have got careers like architect, engineer, architect, designer, landscaper. The most popular course to become an architect is B-Arch. Okay, B-Arch is the most popular course, and through this course, you will be getting the certificate as a certified architect. Okay, Indian Council of Architecture, you become a member of that. Alternative to architecture is BE Planning, BE Construction Technology, and BE Landscape. We come to pure sciences. In pure sciences, we have got physical science, which consists of three major subjects: physics, chemistry, astronomy. Then we have got life sciences, which contains biology, botany, and zoology. And then we have got earth sciences, which has geology, meteorology, and ecology. So if you want to take up pure science, please be very clear as to which branch, which science subject you would like to pursue, because today there are so many options. Let me show the next slide. There are so many combinations offered by science colleges, but be very careful, okay? Do not choose combinations where, I remember a college offering a course like computer science, biotechnology, and physics. At the end of the 3-year course, the student asked me, sir, I'm confused. Nan yen madbeku anta. So adar bagge on clarity irbeku. Don't take many things just because it's being offered to you as a combination. Be very clear that you want to be strong in one domain. So ideally, as a career counselor, what I suggest is you have to choose one particular specialization in your be very, very wide open in your degree, and then move for specialization in your master's. Okay, I will discuss more in the few coming slides. These are the lesser known options in BSc. Dietitian, home science, agriculture, horticulture, oceanography, meteorology, forensic science, dairy technology. All these courses are not having any entrance exam. Okay, agriculture core science, of course, has an entrance exam, right? But apart from that, most of them are offered by the common degree colleges where you can pursue. The benefits and all, you can probably get in touch and discuss when you, if you want to know more about the benefits of these courses. Coming to the last part is, I still feel that if some of you have taken science by chance, tande tai force madidru sir nan beda anta helde nange maths alli by chance 95 bandibittu nange push madibittu science alli adare ivaga maths nodare by seeing the integration symbol I get differentiated andre you have to really have a second thought. Okay, I know most of you are looking for careers in science. At the same time, small percentage of you, few of you are also looking, can I rethink about my life? Can I do the reset button? Like the way God put the reset button on this world through corona, can you put the reset button on your life? Okay, so I just want to explore some options for you in humanities. Humanities means arts. Okay, so few options that you can explore. If you love language, sir, nange English irli, Kannada irli, I'm really good with literature, you can pursue a career in English literature, foreign language, functional English. These are all the options you can choose and be strong in language. My dear friends, words have power. Okay, and if you can make powerful things through words, then you will get royally paid for them. Okay, words have power. Then we've got history. These are the options: BA history, archaeology, anthropology, ancient history. Okay, then social sciences. The list is quite long: sociology, psychology, political science, criminology. Everybody sees every day the crime patrol. Okay, that is fiction, that is created for TRP. But this criminology is going to lead you for a career to work with the government. Okay, BA social work, fantastic options, right? Then journalism and media. So if you want to get into media, especially doing right journalism, doing journalism of, you know, truth, you can do journalism as a full-time course, mass media as a full-time course. And today people are very well paid for public relations. You can actually do a good job in public relations, and you can represent a company, you can represent an organization, an initiative. So there are many courses, and the most popular BA course is BA in journalism, psychology, and English. We come to visual arts. In visual arts, these are the courses available: Bachelor of Fine Arts in Fine Arts, Drawing and Painting, Graphics, Digital Graphics, Interior Design. And to just add something here, the way these courses look so beautiful, the effort is phenomenal. Just because, you know, you like to watch cartoon doesn't mean that you will enjoy making cartoon. Watching a cartoon is different. Designing a cartoon is painful. Only if you have that aptitude, the personality, and the skills, you can definitely do that task of, you know, creating graphics, sculptures, and, you know, using VFX. We come to the less traveled path here in humanities. BA statistics, BA travel and tourism, vocational studies, BA in office administration, office management, human rights, hospitality, physical education, library sciences. These are the options available for those who want to get into humanities. But remember, no matter which course you take in humanities, you should use technology. I'm sure most of you today, by attending this webinar, have realized how all of us sitting at the comfort of our house are able to learn something well. Please, friends, I would highly recommend of all of you to get accustomed to the technology that is available now, and all of you can actually go global. ನೀವು ಹಳ್ಳಿಯಿಂದ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ನೀವು ಎಲ್ಲಾದರೂ ಹುಬ್ಳಿಯಿಂದ ಹಳೆ ಉತ್ತರ ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಕುತ್ಕೊಂಡು, ನೀವು ಬಿಜಾಪುರಲ್ಲಿ ಕುತ್ಕೊಂಡು ನೀವು ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ವೈಡ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಯಾಕೆ? ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಇದೆ. ಆ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಇದೆ, ನಿಮಗೆ ಆ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿಯಿಂದ ದುಡ್ಡು ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ಅವಕಾಶ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ದಯವಿಟ್ಟು ಈ ಲಾಕ್ಡೌನಲ್ಲಿ ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಕಲ್ತ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಹೆಂಗೆ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಂತ. ದೆನ್ ಐ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ ದಿ ಕೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಇನ್ ಲಾ. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ 5-year ಕೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ಲಾ: BA LLB, BCOM LLB, BBA LLB, BSc LLB. These are all the options available in law. And 5-year course, lawyer adre, you have actually no limit for your income. You can become a practicing lawyer. If you get into national law schools, you have a national law schools in our country, there are about 11 national law schools, more are added actually. All odidre you get high paid jobs. So adakoskara CLAT entrance exam ide. Then coming to the last part, that is commerce. In commerce, most of you know that the major areas are banking, investment, finance and accounting, administration management, HR management. Okay, so there are many options. Please be very careful in BCom. Remember that BCom regular is available. BCom regular is available. BCom with CA is available. CS is available. Taxation, tax procedure, travel and tourism, bank management. So BCom regular is what is offered in any college. The rest of the options are offered based on what do you want. It is like if you want to pursue CS coaching, nimage BCom admission sigutte. Aa BCom admission no will be for the evening BCom, andre sayankala time neevu BCom madbeku. Day time alli neevu you will do the internship, you will do the articleship. Adhe rite BCom travel and tourism ide, bank management ide. The difference is from the third semester onwards there will be a different subject, one extra subject iratte which you can use. Now just to tell you how the whole flow of becoming a CA in after second PUC, if you want to become a CA, common proficiency test madbeku, then you have to finish IPCC, then 100 hours of information technology training, then do the articleship, and then clear the final CA exam. Now one thing I want to clear is, if you have scored 100 in accountancy or business studies in second PUC, doesn't mean that you are good to become a CA. Let me explain it here. CA syllabus is different from how a normal BCom course is. It tests you in a very different way. It's not that easy that you can join a CA coaching center and clear your CA. I have seen many students who join the CA intermediate course, and within 1 year, from 100 people in a class, it comes down to 10 because it requires endurance. Andre nimma personality henge irbek andre yene agle nan kashta padodu bidalla, I am not going to give up hard work. Okay, so that is how CA becoming a CA is possible. It takes time. If not becoming a CA, through the ICAI you can become an accounting technician. Like CPT course ide, adadmele 9 months accounting technician course ide, tirga neevu 100 hours id madbeku, ITT ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಒಂದು ವರ್ಷ ಒಂದು ಸಿ ಎ ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ತಗೋಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ಡು ಯು ಬಿಕಮ್ ಅ ಅಕೌಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಿಷಿಯನ್. ಕಂಪನಿ ಸೆಕ್ರೆಟರಿ, ನಿಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರುತ್ತೆ ಸಾಮಾನ್ಯವಾಗಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಕಂಪನೀಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅ ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ರೂಲ್ ದಟ್ ಇನ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಸಚ್ ಕಂಪನಿ ದಿ ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒಬ್ಬರು ಸಿ ಎಸ್ ಇರಬೇಕು, ಕಂಪನಿ ಸೆಕ್ರೆಟರಿ ಇರಬೇಕು. Company secretary is basically a person who will run the company. He is a CEO. So if you become a company secretary, you can apply jobs to become a CEO, and this CEO will not be of a startup. It will be of an already functioning company, which is into business, and it needs somebody to lead the entire team. ಸಾಮಾನ್ಯವಾಗಿ ಕಂಪನಿ ಸೆಕ್ರೆಟರಿ ಮಾಡಿದವರು ಲಾನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಯಾಕೆ? ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಕಂಪನಿ ಸೆಕ್ರೆಟರಿ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ನೋ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ರೂಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರೆಗ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ, ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ, ಹೌ ಅ ಕಂಪನಿ ವರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಅಟ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಟೈಮ್, ಆಸ್ ಬೈ ಲರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಲಾ, ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಲೋ ದ ಲೀಗಲ್ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೌ ದಿಸ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ವರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಮೆನಿ ಕಂಪನಿ ಸೆಕ್ರೆಟರೀಸ್ ದೇ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಲಾ ಸೈಮಿಲ್ಟೇನಿಯಸ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ಪವರ್ಫುಲ್ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಎ ಲಾಯರ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಸಿಎಸ್. Right, and most of the top companies in our country which have full time CEOs, andre avaru salary eshtu irutte, tingalige 10 lakh irutte illa 8 lakh irutte, avrella yarandre avaru cs maadirtare. Aadre sir nanu 5 varsha cs maadkondre at the age of 25 nanage 5 lakh prati tingalu job sigutta? Sigalla. It takes experience. Okay, aa experience takobekandre ee qualification beku. Ee qualification aadmele bahusha ondu 5 varsha 10 varsha experience aadmele you will be paid a high salary job. That is company secretary. Coming to management courses, ivaga tumba jana makkalu second pc maadidare, pc maadi ivaga management course tagolak hogtagira, neevu bba maadabodu. Ivaga bbm anta course illa, bbm has been stopped and now we have got bba. Bba regular option ide, bba in aviation ide, bbi anta ide, bfm anta ide, bms anta ide. These are all courses offered by different universities. And please remember that now in Karnataka, nam Karnatakadalli and all over India, many new universities have come up. They have been approved by the government. These are private universities, so they have the authority to start many new courses. So only when you look into their websites and look at their brochures, you will come to know about the new options being offered. We come to civil services, because civil services is something that is one of the most sought careers in our country. Once you finish your degree, no matter which degree you do, somebody was asking in the chat before the whole webinar started that which is the best degree course for doing IAS. Now let me make it clear here. IAS is a exam which has a totally different syllabus. It goes down to knowledge right from your fifth standard till your degree. Your entire knowledge bank is tested. That knowledge bank has to be organized. That knowledge bank has to be fine-tuned, and that has to be updated when you prepare for IAS exam. So degree aadmele, once you are in final year degree, you can apply for the UPSC exam. The entire duration of the civil service examination is about 1 to 1.5 years. Andre ivaga samanyavagi the prelims happens in the month of August, right? Adakke notification it comes in the month of April. ಆದರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ರಿಪರೇಷನ್ ಶುರು ಆಗೋದು ಮುಂದಿನ ವರ್ಷ ಅಕ್ಟೋಬರ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಅಕ್ಟೋಬರ್, ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಸೆಪ್ಟೆಂಬರ್ ಅಕ್ಟೋಬರ್ ಆಫ್ 2020. ಯು ವಿಲ್ ರೈಟ್ ದ ಯು ಪಿ ಎಸ್ ಸಿ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಪ್ರಿಲಿಮ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ 2021 ಇನ್ ದ ಮಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಗಸ್ಟ್. ಯು ವಿಲ್ ರೈಟ್ ದ ಮೇನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ನವಂಬರ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಿ ಇಂಟರ್ವ್ಯೂಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ 2022 ಮಾರ್ಚ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಐಎಎಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅ ಡಿಗ್ರಿ, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ examination service. Neevu you should write the prelims, clear the prelims, write the mains, clear the mains, and then you go through the interview. There is nothing called the best course for IAS. It is how comfortable you are to give more time for preparing for IAS during that degree. So samanyavagi en martare jana, some people who are very very clear that I will write UPSC only, I will write KPSC only, andre they take up 3-year courses or 4-year course, whatever course, and they take up which is very 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 comfortable for them, because they are very clear, nanage placement beda, nanage bere job beda, I want to do UPSC. So they will score 60-70% in that course, but every day in their degree they will spend 2 to 3 hours preparing for UPSC. So in our country, at the country level you have got UPSC, at state level you have got KPSC. Coming to defense, in defense we have got Indian Army, Indian Navy, and Indian Air Force. So all of you can pursue careers in these three services of the nation, defense services. After your PUC, you can take the NDA exam, NDA and NA, Naval Academy exam. By through that you can enter the Indian Army, Indian Navy, as well as the Indian Air Force. After degree, you can do the combined defense service exam, and you can also do the AFCAT, Armed Forces Common Admission Test. Let me now sum up my entire presentation. I just want to add a few things. This is again as a conclusion to the entire presentation I made. Never ever give up. If you don't give up, you will never fail. Please remember this. If you don't give up, you will never fail. I don't have the video now to play. Maybe I will do it later, if possible. Emerging careers by 2020. So as you see here, this was a survey done in 2018 and it was put forward. And I think in this entire list, the one career that has got really, really stuck now is travel and tourism, because that is what is called real life challenges. See, today, unfortunately, Corona has locked down the entire world, but not every career is locked down. Okay. Of course, infrastructure has been hit, but it will bounce back. Okay. Healthcare is booming, pharmaceuticals is booming, animation and gaming is booming, insurance is booming, logistics is also continuing its place, retail is booming, agriculture is booming, media is stopping nowhere. Okay. The only place that we are stuck here is travel and tourism, because travel has been stopped, so tourism has been stopped. Okay. So out of 20, out of so many, one career has taken a hit, but most of them are going to have challenges. We will settle down in some time. After this program, I would request you all to think outside the box. Okay. Na ade martini, hange irthini, adha solpa change aage. Let's try to, you know, think differently now that you have known so many careers. Remember these don'ts, very important. Don't choose your career by influence of others. Okay. Somebody should not influence you, especially your friends. You know, I know so many friends, maga, nanu, neenu, you know. We are like Jay and Viru of Shole. Now, Vibro, Hengandra, from LKG, we have been together, maga. Now also, friends are always there, my dear friends. But career is yours. Have friends, okay? Don't think that if I go to this course, I will lose my friend. Don't forget, your friend is always your friend. He'll be there or she will be there. But please remember that you should not be influenced because somebody wants you to take a decision for his benefit or her benefit. Don't get tempted by current trends. Okay, I want to caution here. Current trends may show that a lot of careers are, you know, shaken. Why to do medicine? Doctors are dying. Let's be strong. Let's be positive. Okay, we are in a pandemic. It happens once in 100 years. In one way, we should feel ourselves lucky that we are seeing a pandemic. We used to read here, but the current trend should not drop your motivation from joining a particular course. Be strong with your convictions. Don't finalize before you clarify. As I mentioned earlier, it may be a small doubt. Sir, nimge salary eshtu sigutte? Sir, how many people you have to monitor every day? Sir, do you have to travel by bus every day for job? Ask them. Don't assume things. Assumption is the most dangerous thing to do in career selection. Don't be headstrong and decide in state, in haste. Okay. Many students are like tumba students, especially, you know, students who are academically very good, they will fight with their parents. So don't be headstrong, you know. Please relax. This is your career. This is you have to live. Okay. Please don't put parents into such situations. Okay. Your parents are the only two people in this world who will never be jealous of you. So please sit down with them, convince them. Talk to them. Don't fight with them saying that maadre ide maartini illandre yenu maadalla. That's a very dangerous thing to do. Please don't do that. My engineering life, let me share how I did my engineering. I had fun within limits. Of course, I enjoyed my engineering. I had friends, college and beyond. I had friends who helped me and who molded me a lot. Quick learning. I used to, you know, always look at how do I learn quickly. T20 was not invented, but I was doing T20 in my studies. Extracurricular activities. Please, lockdown allu kuda, use your time to develop extra skills. Learn new things. And when you join degree, just don't do a muckpot. And I know principal sir is here. I always tell, please don't have attendance more than 90%. Okay. The remaining 10%, please keep it for productive utilization. don't use that 10% to watch movies, roam around. But I feel an ideal student should have only 90% attendance. 10% should be reserved for doing productive things to make yourself, you know, rewind, restart. Focus, do everything, but focus on your purpose. Do everything. I mean, you go to college, you will have friends, you will have chit-chatting, you will have hostel friends, but please ensure that you focus. It's the time to discover, not disco. Okay, it's the time you discover yourself. Graduation is a great time. I discovered myself in graduation. I was not a person like this in my school and college life. I was a little introvert, but then I realized that, no, this is what I love to do. This is what I can do more and more. So please do that. This is a message I would like to give. Life is like a boxing match. Defeat is declared not when you fall, but when you refuse to stand again. Okay. Defeat is declared not when you fall, but when you refuse to stand up. So don't give it up. Okay. No matter what your result is, what all is happening, don't give up on your dreams. Stick to your dreams. Just to quickly add on here, this is my contact number, my email ID. And of course, everything till now, whatever I have told, I'm sure it would have given you a very big insight into this. And all I can say is that today's webinar is one of the best things to happen for all of you, including me, that we were able to do something productively in this time and choose our careers wisely. And I thank sincerely the management of Sri Sai Ram College of Engineering for giving this opportunity and for making students benefit out of the knowledge I had. And I look forward for more of programs with kids. And thank you so much, Dr. Arun Kumar. Thank you, Principal Sir. Thank you, Patel Sir. And it's over to Malini Madam for the next proceeds.
Thank you so much, sir. It was so phenomenal. You are an amazing speaker. You covered entire thing that what a student can offer, be it engineering, be it medicine, be it graduation, be it anything for that matter. It was fantastic. And I don't think any student can expect any kind of other information if at all they have carried this information back to their place. So now I'm getting the request from one of our students saying that she would like to join the session. Just let's give her a chance. Sir, Principal Sir, if you allow me to give a chance to her to speak, then I think we can go ahead and then she can interact with the students, participants here. Would it be okay, sir?
Yeah. Please.
Okay. Just give me a moment, sir. Just give me a moment. Reggie, sir, could you please unmute Sonal? Yeah. Hi, Sonal. It's great to see you here, that you volunteered, that you would like to join the session, and then you would like to share your experience, and then you would like to speak a few words with the participants. You may please go ahead. And we are all really surprised to see you here. Yeah, please.
Good morning, one and all. Okay, myself Sonal, a final year computer science student from Sai Ram College of Engineering. I am here to share my experience as an engineering student in Sai Ram College. So as a student, when we join any college, we'll have lots of things in our mind, like how the teachers are going to be, how the environment would be. And finally, after 4 years, will I be placed? Where will I be placed? How skilled will I be? So I also joined the college with the same fear in my mind. But as days passed by, the way the teachers would be mingled with the teachers, how they handled us and the way they supported us, all this fear somewhere vanished. And they started supporting us in all the aspects. So automatically the confidence that, yes, I can do something came. The teachers in our college not only supported us educationally, but in all the aspects they supported me. Let it be a dancing talent of me, they identified that and they supported me by sending me to various inter-college competitions. Let it be Bidar or any web video competitions, they supported me in that also. And they used to give me opportunities to present the papers in international conference. So over there, they uplifted the communication skills what I had and boosted confidence that, yes, I can communicate very well or increase that communication skills in me. So I thank all my teachers, not only teachers, but HOD and principal sir too. They support in all the aspects. They not only concentrate in our educational growth, but they make sure that a student in their institution grows all around. So it's not only just the education or talent, even in sports, no matter any field. So if a student just keeps desire that, yes, I have this talent in me, to make sure that they uplift that talent of the student. And as our principal sir told at the starting that scholarships are given to the students, I am lucky to say that I have received the scholarship each and every year till today. This usually motivates the students to do well and move well in the upcoming examinations. While getting the scholarship, the only thing we had to do is just to put little effort, because the teachers, the way they teach was so excellent. I just need to put a little effort to get very nice results, and I got the scholarship all the 3 years. So thanks to the teachers also. Recently, I received the Best Student Award too. As I told you, they look around for a student's all-round development. So here, for getting nominated to this Best Student Award, it was not only based on the education, like how I score each year. It was the way I am in academics, the way in extracurricular activities I am, the way I participate in conferences or have I presented any papers. So all this was only because of the teacher's support, the HOD support, and our principal's support. Without that, I feel that I wouldn't have received this Best Student Award. Later, when we speak, so in engineering college, the main fear of a student would be getting placed. Like, how will I get placed? Where will I get placed? How will I crack the interview? So in our college, Sairam College, the placement officer had taken all this as his personal interest and would conduct several activities just to make sure that each and every student in the institution is well trained to clear an interview. To speak about my experience in placement, the first interview what I attended, I got placed. I cracked the interview and I got placed. So again, it was thanks to MR sir and principal sir, because when they realized that, okay, if a student asks them for a session, like I am weak in such part any part, let it be a group discussion or anything. So they made sure that that facility is given to that student. Because of that, as sir told, 95% of the students have been placed already in our college, just all because of their support and their confidence in us that we can do it, made us all come out with such a flying colors. And being a part of Sairam College was not like, okay, you have to be very professional or something like that. It was like a family. They took care, take care of us like a family. If you're wrong, they tell it very sweetly to us and correct.
Thank you, Sonal. That was so kind of you. A lot of nice words you have put on. And we are also equally proud to have a wonderful student like you, an achiever like you. Best wishes. I think so many students are waiting to listen and interact with our resource person. So let us not take the time. So thanks for coming by and sharing your experience with Sairam. Wish you all the best and for your future endeavors. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Right. Yes, we'll continue, madam.
Thank you, Sonal. Thank you so much for being here with us. And then it was fantastic time with you. Now I request our respected management representative, Dr. R. Arun Kumar, to address the gathering. Yes, sir.
Good morning, everyone, and it was a fantastic presentation. So the event, the session is not yet over. The Q&A is going to start. So I request all the students to stay back. And this is a formal, word of thanks, which I would like to propose for all you who have participated in this wonderful session. And Amin sir, this was one of the best programs I have come across ever. A big round of applause. Though you cannot hear the applause from all of us. But still, a big round of applause to you and for the, in-depth analysis, your case studies, the way you have brought down the presentation, the information you shared, it was very, very, very informative. And I can relate everything, whatever, we feel like sometimes, the students are not taking the right decision. They are failing somewhere in taking the right decision. They have been misled by other people. Like every point you have covered, And you have done an excellent job, sir. Like, we are very happy to have you as the resource person for the day. So thank you so much once again. So I would like to see, for the other student, there are, you know, when sir was addressing, he was delivering his speech, there are a lot of queries and questions that were coming up in the chat window, which we were been making a note of, which sir will also be addressing that. And there was one question, right? You know, it's a myth kind of thing. Like, you talk about engineering, like engineers are going jobless and there are no job opportunities for engineers. So this is something, you know, like it's been circulated among the public. I think just before this, Sonal had come and spoken, and you know, we have, in our college, we have placed more than 95% of the students. What more evidence you needed? The complete placement statistics of the institution has been, you know, put on in the slides, previous slides also. So regarding placements, absolutely, you know, there is no worry about when you come to engineering, and technology is going to be the future. So today we are living with technology. How many of us had Zoom? How many of us had Zoom before 1 month? Now there is no smartphone without Zoom app. So your classes have been run through Zoom. Your fitness activities, you know, your exercise, Zumba has been done. You know, schooling has been conducted through Zoom. Yesterday I received a proposal for our second PU student. They wanted to conduct some online CET crash course. I received a proposal. So you want, you want anything, any food you want, you have to be dependent on the technology. You have to, you know, apply. Today you're not supposed to step out, but the delivery services are available. If you want vegetables, go to BizBasket. You order it, you get it delivered. You want any other stuff, you can go for Amazon. If you want, like, everything is technology based. Even a simple, ordinary business, right from selling vegetable to selling milk, has become, you know, today morning I saw an advertisement in the social media that milk will be supplied. You order it on an app, and they are going to give content milk at your doorsteps. Right from agriculture to everything has been going to be technology based, and there is going to be a huge demand for science students. Like, even in medical also, sir was addressing in the right way. Medical industry is going to come in a big way. It's going to be medicine 2.0, to the best of my knowledge. The same thing applies to technology as well. If you see, the theaters have been shut. I don't know how many of us will go to theater even if it is open now, you know, due to this pandemic panic. So the social media and the OTT medium is picking up. Nowadays, so many movies are getting released in OTT. The movies which are scheduled to release in theaters, they are not getting released in OTT. Like that, everything, the world is completely moving towards a technology base. So definitely, when there is so much scope for technology, there will be opportunities in engineering. And I think sir will also cover. You can also ask your questions with sir, right? With a small note, I would like to quickly thank our beloved chairman and CEO, Mr. Sai Prakash Liyomuthu, for giving us permission for and providing us this wonderful platform to bring sir on board to interact with you all. I would like to sincerely place my thanks and gratitude to our beloved chairman, Sai Prakash Liyomuthu. And I would like to pay my tributes to our beloved founder, Sri M.J. Flying Liyomuthu, who is the key architect of all the Sairam group of institutions. I would like to thank our principal, Dr. B. Sadashirappa sir, for literally he pushed us down. He has pushed us down to get this program organized within a short notice. And I thank you so much for all your encouragement, sir. And I would like to congratulate and thank all the organizing team, all the HODs, all the staff members, student volunteers, who have been active in the last 1 week in communicating this program across all the platforms and bringing on the registration. Though the registration has crossed 500 plus, today we could able to witness only 250 to 300 students have been attending it. So whoever has missed out because of different aspects or technical issues, we may come back to you again, if everything goes well, if the response is encouraging. And once again, I would like to thank our beloved resource person, Sri Aminji, for giving us your wonderful thoughts, and you're going to continue the interaction also now. So, and I would like to thank all the principals of PU colleges, faculty members of the PU colleges, students and parents who have been present in this, Zoom meeting, and for patient listening. Today, technology supported a lot. So though we had rehearsed, we didn't want any technological lapses to happen here. Right from the beginning of the presentation till now, the technology is seamless. The voice is very clear. The video and the slides have come very good. So thanks to the technical team, whoever is behind the scenes. And thanks to everyone who had made this program a successful one. The program is not over. Now the main part of the program is set to begin. So lively, you can interact with the resource person. So there is a raise hand button in your Zoom window. Whoever would like to directly talk to sir, you can raise your hands. Our coordinators will come and assist you. Otherwise, you can put your questions in the chat window. So our moderators will pick up the right questions, whichever the sir has not addressed, it will be asked to sir, and sir will answer all your questions. So thank you all. Thank you once again. So over to Professor Malini again.
Thank you, sir. That was such a wonderful speech that you had delivered. And then thank you so much for giving us an opportunity to hold this talk in spite of all the COVID-19 issues. Going to the most important session of this webinar, Q&A, that is the question and answer session with the students and the participants, and then the parents are waiting for so long. I have picked up few questions which are really, really interesting which the students have posted. And one student has posted that, is the digital marketer post is very attractive or what? And that is going to be one of the questions to begin with. And I think over to you, sir. Shrijit has asked this question, is that digital marketer post is a very lucrative post in the future or what?
Thank you, Shrijit, for the question. Digital marketing has been there for the last 5 years. In the last 5 years, digital marketing has actually taken a very, very big position in the industry, because primarily now companies are investing in doing social media marketing. As a digital marketing expert, you will be working on Facebook, because Facebook is the world's largest platform where you can do targeted marketing. So Facebook is one big platform. Second is Google. Google has two very good platforms called AdSense and AdWords. So through AdWords, you place ads. Through AdSense, you make money. The third thing a digital marketing guy can actually do a lot is through affiliate marketing, content writing, and search engine optimization. These are all complete. It's a combination of multiple skills. One is your ability to write things. Second, your ability to conceptualize ideas. Third is reading the market trends and ensuring that you play with people's buying skills. So digital marketing is taking the role of a marketing person and sell the service or the product to the organization, and you represent them online. So certainly digital marketers, most of them are actually self-employed. They start their own agency. And they have clients. Maybe they have a client of an engineering college or a medical school or some restaurant. So digital marketing is a good career. It's one of the most wanted careers now, but it is driven by a lot of effort. Like, I am also learning digital marketing after COVID-19, because I realized that you cannot be away from where everything is happening. The happening place now in the entire world is Facebook, Twitter, and of course, the most favorite, Instagram, for all the youth. So the great career for digital marketing.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for that insight.
Malini,
yes, sir.
There
yes,
are
sir.
People who have raised their hands. We will try to put them on spotlight so that let them.
Yes.
We have Harsha, Tania.
I would.
Can I take a few from there?
Yes, sir. I will bring them to.
Yes, Sarah. Yes, please.
Just I'll go minute. With Harsha is the first one. I'll unmute Harsha.
Yes,
Harsha, can you go ahead with your question? Is Harsha there?
Harsha, you have to enable, I think whoever wants to talk to sir, you have to enable your video.
Okay. Sania is there, I'll unmute her. Sania is there?
Yes, Sania.
Sanya, you can speak now.
People who have raised hands, please be alert, because we have less time.
Sanya, you are live. You can ask the question. Reggie sir, you can disable the poster so that the person will see on the screen. Stop the screen sharing. Yes, Sanya.
Okay, Sanya is not there. Pooja Murugan is there. Let me unmute her. Pooja Murugan.
Yes, sir. Can you hear me, sir?
Yeah, Pooja. Go ahead.
Sir, I am a biology student, but I have interest in computer science and BCA department. Is it possible, sir?
Okay, so you are studying PCMB or what combination in PUC?
PCMB, sir.
Okay, fantastic. See, all students who are doing PCMB, if you want to pursue computer science or engineering, absolutely no problem. Don't think that those who have done only PCME or PCMCS will be good for engineering. because PUC is only testing your academic ability, whether you can take the stress and score particular marks. Okay, so every student who is doing PCMB will be good enough to pursue computer science as engineering or BCA, as long as you know that you will be able to handle that particular requirement of skill set.
Okay. I think Pooja, you got the answer?
Yeah. Shubham Saha is there.
Yeah, Shubham Saha.
Shubham Saha, you have to unmute yourself if you want to ask any question.
Shubham Saha. Shubham is not there. Nihal, we'll go to Nihal.
Madam, you can, in the meantime, you can ask any other question.
Yeah, there is one very interesting question which the student has asked from QCOM BTD. Is the telecommunication has got good scope in today's world?
Telecom is interlinked, because without telecom, we cannot have computer science happening. Today, if Facebook is investing, what was the investment, sir? I forgot. Facebook invested in Reliance.
$5 billion.
$5 billion. So what is the meaning? What message it sends? So telecom industry is quite the backbone of the entire infrastructure of this country. Without telecom engineers, you cannot do anything. If you and me are sitting comfortably and having everybody live and the stream is happening, it is because the way the telecom industry has positioned itself. So telecom is not bad. It has good scope. But when you join telecom, please remember that you need to scale up to the level of technology expected by the industry. So telecom has good scope. There is absolutely no doubt about that. You can pursue it. If you wish to be only in telecom, you will have options. But you can also explore options in IT by doing telecom.
Okay, that was a fantastic answer. I guess they got the answer for their question. And one more question was very interesting there. I would like to be a hacker and we need some more info.
See, ethical hacking was a term that came many years ago. And India has got some big names in ethical hacking. Here, what happens is there is a bright side and there are dark side. So when you call yourself an hacker, let's call it as a cyber security specialist. So try to, do your graduation with computer science. When you do computer science, you will be exposed to some online trainings, online competitions. If you remember recently, one boy got a job in Google, UK, and he was from a college in Mumbai. And what he did was he used to take part in online coding competitions. So there will be many programs like how you saw in the video of Sairam College of Engineering. A student was telling that she participated in the hackathon. So when you go for these kind of competitions and prove your ability, only then you can think of becoming a cybersecurity specialist. I would not say hacker because that is a illegal term. You cannot hack something. You can become a specialist. And as a software engineer, if you get placed into a company like McAfee, which is into antivirus, and once you go into the company, maybe the company will decide, okay, how do you figure out hackers can work and how can you increase security? So look at it in a positive way. Try to become a cyber security specialist. And all these things can happen to you after you join engineering and especially computer science. And along with engineering, you spend a lot of time behind understanding these things because these are not offered generally as a curriculum. These are add-ons.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for that input. Now 12 participants have raised hand. I think we can admit somebody who is interested and then we can go ahead.
He has already spoken, Pooja Murugan. And I think
Shubham Saha.
Shubham Saha came here.
Okay.
Aman Kumar will unmute.
Yeah.
Aman is there?
No, I don't think so. There is one guy called Chirag. Okay. Chirag?
Karaskar, respond.
Chirag, you can go.
Student ke respond and enter.
Chirag, you can ask a question.
You unmute.
Chirag, okay.
Chirag, you have to unmute.
Okay, madam, you can shoot out the next question meantime.
Sir, between mechanical and mechatronics, which one would you suggest right now?
Chirag, better would be go for mechanical, understand the whole industry, see how the dynamics change, because I always feel now that we are going to live in a world of before corona, after corona.
Okay. Sir.
So I would suggest go for mechanical, understand the whole industry, then you specialize in your master's. Because the moment you do mechatronics, you are limiting your options for your post-graduation. So don't limit the options, because you can always specialize after graduation. Try to get in and ensure that you explore the different areas in mechanical engineering and then choose mechatronics.
Sir?
Yeah.
Who's online?
Yeah, please introduce.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
This is Pushpa.
Yes, Pushpa.
Sir, I need some guidelines to become a forest officer.
Okay, great. See, forest officer is a examination that is being conducted by the government. That is open for all the graduates.
Okay.
Generally, they open it for science graduates, but of the late, I think they open up for all graduates. There is something called Indian Forest Service. So the Indian Forest Service is also UPSC. So when you take up the UPSC exam, when you take up the exam of UPSC, and if you don't get the high cadres like IAS, IFS, IPS, or IRS, then you have all the group A services like Indian Railway Service, Indian Road Service, Indian Foreign okay. Service. So complete your graduation. Once you do your graduation, you will definitely have opportunity at an All India level as well as a state level to become a forest officer.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for that insight. Many of the students are asking, is the BE and BTech same or are they different?
BE and BTech are same in terms of the content. The only that BTech is offered by selected universities in that format. The format in which the degree is offered is defined by BE or BTech. But the value it holds is same. Some universities, like Tamil Nadu, most of the colleges offer BTech. Karnataka, they offer BE. In Karnataka, some private universities offer BTech. Okay, so absolutely no difference in job market. BE, BTech are same.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. There is one question from one of the students. He's asking, if I do not like coding, what are my options in engineering?
If you do not like coding, if you are pursuing computer science engineering, then you can get into other stuff like testing. Testing is one big area, because every product that is coded is tested by a team called testers. Then you can also choose options in network management, okay, or technology management. So that is why when you go to engineering, the first year is common for everybody. Learn everything. In second year, you are introduced with one or two subjects of that particular branch, by which you get to know how this branch works. And finally, when you come to the third year, you get electives. You can choose. So that is where you decide whether you want to go into something that's to do with coding or non-coding. Right. And as a reality, what I am seeing now is a lot of students are joining engineering and then they are thinking after engineering what, because they want to experience engineering as a course, because engineering molds you into something. It molds you into a person. It puts you through a jugaad. A lot of engineering students, you know, they end up with more jugaad in their mind and they are able to take better decisions. So there are opportunities in IT infrastructure. You could get into IT infrastructure. So placements are not limited to, you know, what you have studied. Placements are linked to also how you have used your better time during engineering to learn new things. So if you do that, I'm sure you will get more benefits.
Hello.
There is one student who is trying to call.
Is it Raghavendra?
Raghavendra wants to speak.
Sir, I am a biology student, sir.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
how if I want to grab, if I want to choose for ISRO scientist, what way I have to choose?
You want to become a scientist with ISRO, right? Okay, see, ISRO deals with the entire satellite stuff and, you know, all the research India does regarding space. So most of the openings in ISRO are for people with BSc in physics or mathematics, right? And also for engineers. So if you are a biology student, then when you say biology, what I'm assuming is you are doing PCMB, right? Are you pursuing PCMB or PCB home science? If you have physics, chemistry, maths in your second PUC, then you join any degree course with physics or with mathematics. And then when ISRO does a call for engineers, you can apply for the job and they will take you, they will train you, and from there you move on. But ideally, I would suggest do engineering in electronics or computer science or mechanical or electrical to pursue a career in research or to become a scientist. And of course, then masters will be required. It depends on the position where you want to end up in ISRO.
Thank you, sir, for that. And there are certain questions about journalism, agriculture, and biosystem engineering, and how to connect the biology to the technology, nutrition and dietetic course, and then chemical and petroleum engineering. And if there is time to say, then you can give a brief about chemical and petroleum engineering or any of these questions. Otherwise, we can go to the participants who have raised their hand.
See, by and large, if you talk about nutrition and dietetics, completing this course is very easy. You will also do masters, whether it is dairy technology or dietitian or nutrition. Once you finish your graduation, your initial jobs will be very, very challenging. The reason is these are things people prefer after some time. Like, I will not go to a dietitian as fast as I go to a doctor. Okay. So I would go to a dietitian only when something happens little seriously, or I'm very seriously conscious about my health. Okay. So how many of us rush to a dietitian? There is a scope for these people. There is a market for these people. At the same time, these are all things which will sell based on your client's feedback. Like most of the people who are very good dietitians or nutritionists, they are referred by somebody. Like, I would not directly Google a dietitian. I will ask my friend, do you know any dietitian I would like to meet? So if he knows a good dietitian, he will refer me. Okay. Coming to petroleum as a career, see, petroleum, the most employment in the petroleum industry happens on the gas oil fields, which are not on the earth. It's not on the field, it's on the water. So most of the petroleum engineers are responsible for digging oil wells, exploring new oil wells, extraction, processing. So the petroleum engineers whom I know closely, they say that their work lifestyle is quite hectic, and they end up working 18 hours a day, 20 hours a day. So understand the lifestyle. Understand the lifestyle. The tougher the lifestyle, the better you get paid. Okay. Coming to chemical engineers basically use chemical combinations to solve various problems. They also closely work with other technologies. Okay, today with the advancement of, you know, IT, chemical processes have changed. They look at providing solutions to different industries, and they work basically with different chemical combinations to come up with solutions for different industries. Now, for example, if somebody wants to manufacture masks for in N-masks, say 1 million masks, which will be taken up by school children, okay, and they want it lightweight, and they want it, you know, something that can be non-washable, because once COVID is out and the lockdown is down, we may see a situation where masks will become mandatory for every citizen for next 1 year. We don't know. So the chemical industry may work out something which is going to, you know, be easily worn, easily washable. So these are the solutions they work with.
Sir?
Any other? Yeah.
Sir, and AJBSC guidelines, please, sir.
Come again?
AGBSC, Agriculture BSc.
What do you want about that, Agriculture BSc?
The aspects to get free seat in government college. Achha,
achha. Okay, so for agriculture in Karnataka, if you want to get a government seat, then you will have to write. After you write the Karnataka seat examination, you will get an agriculture rank. So depending on ranking and the availability of seats and the availability as per the quota, okay, you will be eligible for the course. Agriculture is always a career which has gone through the good, bad, and great times. What happens is, if you are joining agriculture, then you need to be very clear that agriculture is not just about, you know, you helping farmers. It also includes agriculture marketing, agriculture economics, agriculture research. Okay, and the biggest reason why people take agriculture as a career is because it has got huge application base. Like in India, we have got at least 70% population in working in agriculture. So that is the biggest thing that we need to see.
Okay, thank you so much, sir. Thank you for that insight on BSc Agriculture. There are some questions. What are the prospects of getting the government jobs after studying electrical and electronics engineering, mechanical engineering, telecommunication engineering?
See, every branch of engineering gives you the option for government job. Now, how does the government recruit? The government will recruit they issue a notification, and they have government companies, public sector companies like NTPC is there. Then we have got a BHEL, BEML. We've got many, many government-run companies. Okay, these are public sector companies. Now, if you get a job there, it's like a central government job. But most of the recruitment happens based on vacancies. And there is something called Indian Engineering Service. After you complete your engineering, you can pursue Indian Engineering Service. And through that, you can enter into the government jobs which are marked under the engineering service position in all these public sector companies run by government.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much. There is one question. Can I take up the college which gives the best placement while going for the counseling, or how do I decide about the college where I need to join? Is it with a good ranking or with a good placement?
Yeah, this question is always there. See, I can tell is placements which are offered by different colleges. Okay, placements are offered by different colleges. Like you just saw the current college which we have here, Sairam College of Engineering. Placements is a game that is played in a very, very tough competition. Okay, colleges work hard. They work hard to interact with industry experts. Okay, it depends on college reputation. It depends on college marketing skills and how the college is able to, you know, interact with the old alumni, the current alumni, and they have a very, very strong placement process. What my suggestion would be that you have to look into the different track records of the college, not just the placements. You see the placement. Second, your accessibility for that. Third is, are you getting the branch where you can put the effort? Are you able to will you be able to put your best effort in that? Because placement is the result of a hard work of the students of that particular college, and you also need to match that hard work. Of course, the college plays a big role in identifying the right kind of companies for placements. But when you are choosing your career, be very clear that, are you really made for mechanical engineering? Understand the subject, understand the toughness of the subject, because just because you are sitting in some sort of a vehicle doesn't mean that you will also fly in that vehicle. Okay, because I'm sure when you go, I think the best option could be that you could visit Sairam College of Engineering. If you are in Bangalore, you can see what exactly is. And in your neighborhood, you know, speak to people who are doing that subject. Get a clarity on the branch first. Be clear with the branch, because branch is something that you are going to always say. You will not say, I'm an engineer. You will say, I'm an electronics engineer. I'm a computer science engineer. I'm an agriculture engineer. So choose the branch and then choose the college. Okay. And choosing the college, you know, all the formalities that you have to do, and accordingly take a good decision.
So thank you, sir. There is one question by Srijit. What are these scholarships are for? I think our Arun sir can be able to help this student by giving an insight about it.
Yeah, I will do that. And before that, we have one more young man who is here to ask the question. Yeah, go ahead, Pratik.
AI machine learning and robotics alongside or both have separate careers to take up?
Machine learning is available for everybody. Like computer science engineers also learn machine learning. Mechanical engineers also learn machine learning. Anybody who is into automation of the system, they are into machine learning. Robotics is a specific field where you create machines for doing different tasks. Now, robots have come in so many different areas. Robots have come in restaurants. They have come at airports. They have come at schools. So robots are programmed to perform tasks and robots are customized. Machine learning is basically a technology which is used to program things and to automate them and to ensure that the human error is stopped. So machine learning is different from robotics. Okay, and machine learning can be used or is used for robotics. I'm not clear about that, but robotics itself is a standalone thing. It requires it's a combination of electronics, computer science, instrumentation technology, robotics, because you need to use all these three.
Okay. You got the answer, Pratik.
Yeah, I will just intervene here and answer your own question. Looks like a few students are interested in knowing about the scholarships, what you're offering in our college.
Yes.
So actually, as covered in the presentation, like we are giving scholarships in the name of Leo Muthu Scholarship, which is our founder chairman. And there are two types of scholarships that we have been offering. One is the time of admissions. I think, Mr. Reggie, you can show that on the screen. And the time of admissions based on your plus two PCM aggregate, physics, chemistry, max aggregate on the management quota seats. Like if your percentage range is like this, if you have got 90% and above, then you will be getting 39,000 scholarship on your fee structure right away in the first year itself. And after once you join engineering, there is another level of merit scholarships what we are offering based on your CGPA. So in the first year, what is going to be your CGPA based on that? If you're getting 9.5 CGPA, which is around 92%, if you get around 9.5 CGPA, the entire fees what the students are paying has been returned back. I think one of such beneficiaries is Sonal. Like last 3 years, she has taken away all 3 years fees what she has paid towards the college. So abundant of scholarships are on offer for the meritorious students and for the performers. And apart from that, for project students, whoever is going for international competitions like Singapore, they have gone, Dubai, they have gone to Iran, Korea. Wherever they are going for them also, we are giving a lot of sponsorships and scholarships. So, and admissions are open. Like this scholarship, the admissions, other scholarships are for everybody. It's open for everyone, for all the performers. But whereas for admission-related scholarships, it's for the limited management quota seat because only we have hold on only the management quota seats. We do not hold on government seats and the common case seats. So, in the management quota seats, we are giving away a lot of scholarships. The sooner you come and take the admission, now already the pre-booking is going on, the admission inquiry numbers have been flashed on the screen. The sooner you come and take admissions, you will be given a lot of surprise packages kind of thing because it depends on the seat. We have some percentage of seats allotted. Even there are some seats earmarked for some merit students on government fee structure itself. The management fees, though it comes around 1,30,000 plus, the government fees will come hardly around some 89,000 or 90,000 rupees. Even there are some takeaway, some seats available for other branches, in the government fee structure itself. Only thing what we need to do is you have to visit our college website and register there. And from there on, our counselors will guide you stage by stage. And as resource person said, once the lockdown is over, you can plan to come and visit our institution. And there are a lot of many things to see, witness, like, our innovation centers. The college is totally different, entirely different from the normal conventional working institutions, any other engineering college. This college is totally different. And you have to come here and come down to our campus and witness that to know more about the college. Definitely, the scholarships are going to be a very big boon for all the performance and meritorious students. So get in touch with us. We will give you more and more information about that. And as I said, the pre-booking is going on. Visit our website and do the registration to take admissions in our college. Then over to resource person again.
Okay, any questions we have? I think a few more hands are raised.
Yes. I will next we will give chance to Aishwarya.
Okay.
Yes, you may ask the question, Aishwarya. Someone by name Aishwarya. Yes, Aishwarya. Once you have to unmute yourself. Aishwarya, you have to. Yes, go ahead.
Can you hear me, sir?
Yes, Aishwarya.
Okay. Yeah. Yes, sir. I just want to ask you like some variants about BTech. Actually, there are many options in BTech. And how can I know that which one is better for me?
Okay. Which are the variants that you are aware of now? BTech and what all?
I have no clue about it, actually. But then I just want to know like properly how BTech works and what are the available options for BTech?
Aishwarya, BTech is equal to BE. Okay. And BTech is offered as the nomenclature is different from different universities. All the IITs or the NITs offer BTech, as well as various states in India, they offer BTech as a degree. If you're planning to do in Karnataka, then most of the colleges in Karnataka offer a BE. The variance is as simple as the branches that are listed out for you. During the presentation, I sent a complete list. Right from computer science to electronics, mechanical, electrical, telecom, agriculture, mining. There are so many options. What you need to do now is you need to follow the, if you have joined the webinar at the beginning, I laid out a process. The process is you need to identify what you are good at. You know, what are your qualities in terms of your ability, your personality. Okay. And the third factor should be your interest. Interest should never be the first factor. Say, for example, if you're fascinated about doing something using IT, then computer science stands out because you need to be good with, you know, understanding reasoning ability, numerical ability. Okay, these are things required. So what question you have put is a broad question, which I fear that I may not be able to do justice answering here. Probably you can get in touch with me later on. All I can say is that you need to drill down with few options because this is a huge question that you have asked. There are so many and everything is great. I mean, I would like to say, except for the two branches, which I personally feel nobody should pursue in these tough times, biotechnology and aeronautical, I would personally tell everybody should focus on doing engineering and excelling in that. When you join engineering, if you don't excel, then you are missing out something. So let's have that clarity on that clarity.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome.
Yes, Malini madam, you have any questions from the chat?
Yes, sir. There is one question from Dania Kausar Beg, who is waiting from half an hour. She's telling like she wants to know about life sciences and what do we want to have a career in biology. So what she wants to, she's requesting me to connect you. Yeah.
Can you correct her?
She is not on the, she has not raised her hand, but she's requesting it in the chat room.
Okay. I'll answer it because she can hear us and the question has come. See, Dania, the options that you have in biology, especially in life sciences, is you need to pursue a BSc course. BSc in with zoology as an option. It's popularly called as CBZ. I would not recommend pursuing microbiology as an option. I would highly recommend pursuing BSc in zoology, okay, CBZ. And after that, you will realize that you can do your master's in any one particular thing, either botany or zoology. Okay, so that will be an ideal career path. Now, the other question that you asked was, what was the question, Malini madam? Botany, she asked about life sciences and careers in biology. So,
she wants to know about life sciences and biology, career in biology.
Okay. See, when you talk about career in biology, what I will interpret here is you want to stick to biology as a subject, right? Because career options with biology is a different question, but the question is careers with biology. Most of them who pursue their BSc and further do their masters with botany or zoology as their specializations, they get the opportunity to do JRF, Junior Research Fellowship. Once you do your JRF, then you get your SRF, Senior Research Fellowship, and through that, you can ultimately complete your PhD. So when you do your PhD, you become eligible for two big jobs. One is research, the second is teaching. Okay. In our country, over the last few years, the requirement to be a professor at the university level has increased. Most of them are required to have their PhDs. So you can pursue your PhD and be there, okay? Or if you do your master's, you can end up with becoming a lecturer or a professor in college. Yes, madam.
Yeah. I think that that gives her the answer. And with this, we have an important announcement to all the participants. We will be sharing a link where the feedback form need to be submitted. All the participants, whoever submits this, whoever fills this form and then submit, will get the e-certificate for attending this session. So do not miss the opportunity of getting the e-certificate of entering into this session and then taking the good bits from our resource person. And with this, I think we have got one or two questions left out. Shall we proceed?
Mr. Ravi Teja is online. I put him on for that.
Yes.
Ravi Teja?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Hello, sir.
Yeah, yes, Ravi.
Sir, my question may be very odd. Sir, I'm PCMC student. Hello.
Yeah, we can hear you.
Sir, I'm interested in computer science, B.Tech, sir, but I'm also interested in politics. So I am asking, there is any course for politics?
Okay. See, Ravi, I don't know how do I answer this question. See, politics, adventure, photography, wedding planning, okay, wedding photography. When you talk about these careers, you know, these are all careers which come through a lot of inner passion and drive. So if I see that you want to become a computer science geek or computer science engineer, and then you want to become a politician, first thing is stabilize your revenue resources. Okay, like how do you get revenue? All I can say is that today most of the people who are doing well in politics are economically stable. Okay, so they can talk, they can do what they like and everything. My suggestion would be that once you join degree, be part of youth initiatives. There are many youth initiatives in this country. You can take part in them. You can learn. You should be a public personality if you want to get into politics. And it is here that you don't have control over your own future when you talk about careers like this. Okay, because these all depend on a lot of dynamics. So my suggestion would be that focus on one or two skills that will pay you nicely. Get into revenue generation mode first. First, you need to have something that pays you. Because I don't think at this moment politics pays, okay? It's a very tricky question to answer, so I don't want to be on any side of politics. All I want to say is, as a youngster, develop multiple skills. Definitely, you should show interest in whatever you feel is your interest. Give time for that. But try to be different. If you seriously look at something as a career in politics, you should look up to what Prashant Kishore did. If you look up on internet, who is Prashant Kishore, you will know who he is and what he has done in the last 6-7 years and how he has made money by working with politicians. So I would recommend a career like Prashant Kishore. Okay. So look into who he is.
Okay, here we have Prajna Ashok next. Prajna, you can unmute yourself and ask the question.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, Prajna.
Good morning. So basically, my question was related to Ayurveda and BS, because most of them are like thinking that preferring Ayurveda is not a good option in this generation, because English medicine has more value than Ayurveda. So can you please talk about that?
Okay. See, today medicine is seen from the eyes of the person who wants the cure. Now, say for example, yeah. I'll give you my own example. I am a patient of slip disc. Okay, mm-hmm. Slip disc is like one of in the backbone, the last part between two joints. There is a ligament which comes out, right? So I would first go to Ayurveda treatment. I would not go for the modern medicine, because modern medicine, they will cut open, they will do something, and then I have a lifelong problem. Okay, so I am exploring alternative medicine. So given the current lifestyle and the health style which most of the people are going through, I don't see the demand for Ayurveda has gone down. The demand, especially after Patanjali came in and the way Baba Ramdev was able to promote Patanjali such a big way. Okay. Ayurveda has positioned itself in a very strategic way, and people want them to be cured. See, no patient would be ready for a surgery. Let us take this. People resort for a surgery only when they realize that this is impossible without a surgery. But I have seen nature cure hospitals where they use naturopathy. But these hospitals don't use only naturopathy. They use naturopathy, they use Unani, they use Ayurveda. They combine everything. Because at the end of the day, they want to make the patient get cured of that ailment. Okay. So I have visited nature cure hospitals where they charge a bomb. And I feel that doing Ayurveda is no less compared to doing MBBS. But when you pursue Ayurveda or Unani or homeopathy, please don't underrate yourself. Do good, give your best. People are there to pay you as long as you deliver them results. So there's nothing underrated with Ayurveda. It's equally good. And I always say, no matter which course you go, I'm telling for everybody here, whatever you do, if you can put 500% in what you are doing, you will stand out, you will be paid. See, in my case, I did engineering, right? And after engineering, out of 120, I decided to be a counselor. We were 120 students in my class of engineering. Okay, and I went to one of the best engineering colleges in the country. But why did I choose to become a career counselor? Because I believe that I can do counseling better than an engineer. Okay, so the belief system in each one of you, if you're pursuing mechanical, believe that you will one day achieve fame, achieve name. Okay, so a lot of self-motivation is required. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Adding to your answer, like, you know, our Sairam is a group of institutions, and we have Ayurveda, Siddha and Homeopathy medical colleges, not in Bangalore, but it is in Chennai. So if you're interested in pursuing Ayurveda degree, you can get back to us through the helpline numbers what you are given, and we can give you more insights, you know, exclusively for Ayurveda. I can connect you to the best doctors, Ayurveda doctors, where you can interact and know more information on that. So then, madam, you have any questions from the chat? Professor Malini? Okay, meantime, Banu Prasad, I'll put you on spotlight so you can ask your question. Is Banu Prasad here?
Yes, sir. Hello.
Yeah, please.
Sir, this automobile engineering and computer science, sir.
Okay, automobile is totally different, Banu. Banu Prasad, because automobile is
his
understanding is the way the automobile engineering is different, automobile design is different, and computer science is different. If you do an exclusive automobile engineering course, most of your employers will be people who are into manufacturing of cars, buses, trucks, etc. Okay, mostly cars. So if you pursue automobile engineering, your end location will be the automobile industry, where you are primarily going to be in charge of designing the engines, designing the functionality of the automobile, not designing the outlook, because that is done by an automobile designer. So if you are again in automobile confused that I want to design how a car looks, then you need to become an automobile designer. Automobile engineers primarily work with the way the engine is performing, the performance part. Computer science, of course, is totally different from automobile. But computer science is part of automobile, but automobile is not part of computer science. See it that way.
Yes, sir. Sir, and for automobiles, is there any separate courses?
We have a full-time degree, no? You have a BTech in automobile.
Oh, okay, sir.
But I would recommend you to do mechanical. Do mechanical, then explore. See, at the end of the engineering, you have to be very strong in your willpower to join any organization.
Yes.
What happens when placements happen is your confidence is seen. Okay, I'm sorry, but I have to quote that the three idiots scene, you know. That guy says, "Bahut mushkil se shab, ye sab choda hai." You know, I mean, of course, it's a scene. It's directed. It's a movie. But in real term, the kind of confidence you need to have about your ability at the end of any engineering course is actually going to impact your placements. Okay, build all those soft skills. And I forgot to mention about soft skills during my entire program. Soft skills play a very big role in your employment tomorrow. So ensure that you have those soft skills.
And adding to that, like in future, if you want to go, you know, take a gate examination or something, that you have to write your examination in mechanical engineering, if I'm right. So there is no automobile paper is, you know, available for writing, you know, the gate examinations. And as long as undergraduate is concerned, even my advice, you know, I'll go along with the counselor. Like, keep it your core branch. Don't go for specialized branches like robotics, mechatronics. Don't go for specialization. So specialization, obviously, you can pursue in your higher education. But undergraduate, try to keep your core as the base. That is highly recommended. I think sir also will agree with me.
Yeah, I totally agree. I always recommend engineering, keep it very, very core, mother branches. Specialization, you can do so many things. And during
sir,
engineering...
BTech is better.
Yeah, we have, see, BTech, BE, both are same. Ma. Both are no difference. Both are
yes,
same.
Sir. Thank you, sir.
I think we have Nihal. Nihal, you can ask your question. Is Nihal with us? Yeah, Nihal.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah, yeah.
Yes, Nihal.
Yeah, so I basically like to do aeronautical engineering. Mm-hmm. And I want to succeed my dream making a aircraft which runs on electricity.
Okay.
Should I pursue my dreams or just go for my financial stabilities?
See, aeronautical industry has been one of the highest paid and one of the most attractive, lucrative industry. Okay. I have known one of my friend is an aircraft engineer and he's an aeronautical engineer. His basic qualification was mechanical. He did mechanical, and further, after doing his mechanical engineering, he applied for companies like Accenture, Airbus, where there were openings for aeronautical engineers with certain skill set. What I would recommend is you need to take a stand here. Are you really going to, you know, push yourself so hard in times when the opportunities are less? Okay, because if you see the opportunities for aeronautical engineers are limited in this country, limited, very limited. Say for example, for 100 jobs, you've got about 10,000 people applying. Okay, the same thing could be achieved by doing mechanical. Okay, the success rate of doing aeronautical engineering and eventually becoming an aeronautical engineer is less. Okay, the success rate of doing mechanical engineering and pursuing courses to do with aircraft design are more. Because I know a company which offers internship and they charge close to around 50,000 rupees if you want to intern with them. And once you intern with them, you are going to be absorbed by them as an aeronautical engineer. Okay. So understand, try to reach out to people who are working as aeronautical engineers. If you don't have an account, open an account in LinkedIn. Okay. I hope all of you have an account in LinkedIn. All of you have a LinkedIn account? No. Okay, try to make an account in LinkedIn, reach out to professionals, read with them, understand with them. Because you're all still 17, 18, but if you can get into areas like LinkedIn, you will be able to, you know, get exposed to better professionals, read more from them.
Okay, here we got Ammu Gowda. She has some questions to ask. Ammu, you can ask.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, hello.
Sir, this is Amrita.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
and studying PCMB, sir, biology. I took biology.
Mm-hmm.
So I have a doubt of whether I have to take a gynecologist in medical or Ayurvedic, sir.
See, Ammu, gynecologist. See, gynecology is a specialization,
yes,
after you do medicine. Okay, so to be a gynecologist,
okay,
you
sir.
First need to be a doctor. You need to be an MBBS doctor and then study
okay.
hard to do your MD.
Okay, sir.
But becoming an
okay.
Ayurveda physician is choosing BAMS
mm-hmm.
as an option after your PUC. Ivaga neevu NEET madidira. Okay, NEET agila, sorry.
Yes,
you will finish your PUC, you will finish your
applied.
NEET. Yeah,
yes,
you have
sir.
Applied. If you complete your MBBS, then you can do MD gynecology. Similarly, if you complete your BAMS, in BAMS also in MD, there is a specialization called gynecology. It has a term. It has a Sanskrit term, which I don't remember now. Okay, it will be called MD something. So the basic thing is you need to do a medicine 5.5 year course. And after that only you can decide upon gynecology, pediatrics, orthopedics.
Okay.
That's the logical step.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Do well for your NEET. Get into a good medical course.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Welcome.
Yeah, go ahead. Who's the Realme C2? What's your name?
Realme C2.
I'm Rakshit, sir.
Hi, Rakshit. Yes, Rakshit.
Rakshit.
Yes, Rakshit.
Can you hear me, sir? Can you hear me, sir?
Yeah, now we can hear you.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
I want to pursue computer engineering, and I'm planning to become an entrepreneur. So, should I do BA after BTech, or is there any other alternative?
Should I do
MBA after
MBA? Okay. See, what has happened is a lot of engineering graduates have become entrepreneurs as well as YouTubers. Today, India's leading YouTubers are engineers. Okay, that's a fact. What happens in engineering is, it's a juga. I'm an engineering graduate. That's why I can speak for engineering. You are exposed to such a rigorous workout, the internals, the assignments, the inter-college competitions. During these 4 years, you have to make solid friends. Okay. You have to make people with knowledge as your friends. You have to travel. Then you will somehow hit an idea. Okay. If I take this idea with this team, I can become an entrepreneur. And you need to read a lot of books. Especially, you know, I read this book called Stay Hungry, Stay Foolish, which was a story about all the IIM Ahmedabad graduates who went on to build India's top companies. So during graduation, you will come to know where exactly the markets are moving. You need to read magazines. There's a magazine called The Entrepreneur. You need to participate in webinars like this. You need to scale up very fast. So at one stage, you will realize that I am good for entrepreneurship. Then you need to have a mentor. The mentor will tell you, should you do an MBA or should you jump immediately after your graduation? Or should you do a job, earn some money and say, because entrepreneurship is investment. Somebody will invest, you will spend. And remember, when you do entrepreneurship, when you take somebody's investment, you are definitely bound to answer to people. So it's a complex thing. At right now, I want to tell you one thing. Do your engineering very well in computer science. Keep your hands very strong on one particular domain. If you know the story of Oyo Rooms, okay? The founder of Oyo Rooms is an engineering college dropout, and he used to sit and code in the night, and in the day, he used to attend the people coming to that hotel to understand psychology. And within 3 years, he built Oyo, and today Oyo, I mean, of course, now it's down because of COVID, but otherwise Oyo became as big as Airbnb and others. So do your engineering and try to do it as much from a college which gives you all the environment. And Arun Kumar, sir, do you have entrepreneurship development programs in your college?
Yes, sir. Actually, we are very well known for it. We have an entrepreneurship development cell exclusively working for it. And we have IEDC, Innovation and Entrepreneurship Development Cell, sanctioned from the government, Department of Science and Technology, where you receive 50 lakhs fund. So if a student is having a project idea which is marketable, he can come and propose it to the cell. And the cell will give up to 1 lakh seed money to develop the project. The discretion of the sanction is with the institution. Though we receive the funds, on the behalf of the selection committee, if the idea is good, we can fund up to 1 lakh. So this is about the IEDC. And also last year, we have got our MSME, business incubator cell sanctioned. So we have got the business incubator where if a student is having an idea of starting his own business, straight away if the project idea is selected by the committee, means the internal committee, and if it is recommended to MSME, they will get up to 15 lakhs fund. So with 15 lakhs, beautifully you can, and moreover the space, office space, the laboratory spaces, the R&D space, everything we will give up from the college. So if anybody wants to start their business and if their aspiration is to become an entrepreneur, there is a lot of encouragement from the government. And in the first phase, if an idea is good and if it is, it has come out very good, the company is successful. The next phase also, they are extending further 25 lakhs. You know, so much of grant in aid has been sanctioned. It's not a loan. Again, I'm repeating, it's a grant to start up your ideas. And a lot of engineering colleges are encouraged about it. And Sairam is proud to have one such business business incubator set up in our college. A lot of encouragement is there. Are almost 29 startups, sir, from our college.
Oh,
we
great.
Have to 12 patents we have in our institution. Great. I think nowadays, this young generation is very smart. And, you know, they know how to make money. They are good place students. You know, there are so many place students who have not gone and reported to the company. Rather, in turn, they are working in our incubation center and they are working on their business ideas. A lot of encouragement and a lot of connect. We have 20 years old alumni association. We have
Bangalore is the startup capital of India, friend.
And we have
7,000 startups in Bangalore.
Yes, sir. 20 years old alumni association. Our people are in, so many of our alumni are angel investors. So many of our alumni are in very high position who are ready to invest for students' projects. They are very well connected and they are also mentoring our students, whoever is going to go with the startups. Lot of encouragement is there. That is another big session what we can have exclusively. So how many more questions you can take up, sir? It's already 1 o'clock.
We will have 10 more minutes.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, we'll finish in 10 minutes. Somebody is behind teaching.
Who's that? Srivatsava.
So, yeah. He is from 1 hour. What about teaching?
Srivatsava, I'm putting you on. I think you have to disable your video, man. You have to enable your video. Srivatsava, if you want to have the question.
Is there?
No, his video is shut. Meantime, I just put one more student. Who is that?
We have somebody in Yashaswini, Pooja.
Yashaswini.
Hello, good morning. Good evening, sir. Good afternoon, sir.
Okay.
Hello.
Yeah. Thank you. You said all the three things. Very nice.
Sorry. I was nervous. My area of interest is mathematics.
Excellent.
So what should I take up, sir? Engineering or BSc or what, sir?
Ideally, you should take up medicine,
Actually, I wanted to, but financially, it's difficult. So, okay. I dropped down.
Okay. I was just putting this as an important observation I have done. Most of the best doctors in the country, if you do a research, they are all people who were good with maths. I know doctors who scored 100 on 100 in maths and still did medicine. That was just to tell how mathematics is very useful for even people who want to do medicine as a career. Now, coming to mathematics, if you are strong in mathematics and if you really want to be a person known for mathematical abilities, then I would recommend a BSc in statistics. It's offered by Indian Statistical Institute. You could explore the options there. In fact, they also give a 2000 rupee fellowship also. Every month they give a fellowship of 2000 rupees. That is, again, you need to check all the details and get from there. Now, with regards to what other things you can do, you can pursue engineering, because engineering, at least for the first 4 semesters, you will have mathematics as a core subject. And if your mathematics is good, you will easily be able to do other things very quickly and fast. So aspire, here comes your aspiration. What do you want to see yourself and what kind of a job you want to see yourself? Computer science would be ideal for anybody who has a very strong love for mathematics. So I would recommend computer science as a branch. I'm just recommending, I'm not saying that this is the best thing for you. Do explore these two options, computer science engineering and a BSc in statistics, as well as a BSc in maths honors. Okay, but then that will lead you to a career in teaching. And let's also realize that teaching is one of the most important careers we all see. And we'll all, as long as you are very well qualified, you are having good jobs available.
Hello.
And adding to sir, when it comes to mathematics, there is a new avenue which is open, which is very challenging and is having a very huge demand in market, which is on data science.
Exactly.
Computer science, yes, sir. Computer science with, you know, data science, anybody cannot do. Every computer engineer cannot do data science. They need to have very strong mathematic, you know, fundamentals.
Correct.
So computer science, doing some certification course or some specialization in data science is going to land you in the, you know, the best career in the world.
Today, data is oil.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Okay,
sir. Hello. Right?
Hello.
Yes, who's that?
Hello, sir. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
We can hear you. Who are you?
Sir, my name is Mohammed Zabiullah.
Yes, Zabiullah.
Sir, I am interested in marine engineering as well as, like, if it is not possible, like, for marine biology, is there scope for in India for it?
See, marine engineers and marine biologists, they work with the government as well as the private industry, which works out of the seaport, sea line of India. Because most of the marine related jobs are not there on the land, they are on the seashore. So there is something called Indian Maritime University, which conducts an exam for admission to all the Indian maritime institutes across the sea line of India. You have colleges from Kolkata to Vishakhapatnam, Chennai, then Kochi, Karwar and Mumbai, the entire, you know, sea line. So marine biologists, they are the people who are going to be engaged with exploration, understanding marine life, taking expeditions on behalf of companies, exploring what is on the ocean bed. So it is a life of adventure, thrill, and also a lot of dangers. You have to clear the Indian Maritime University entrance exam to get admission there. The Indian Maritime University generally conducts the entrance exams in the month of April. But I'm sure because of the COVID, that has also been postponed, and it may be available at what time, we don't know. So look out for Indian Maritime University website, and from there you will get more information.
And is it advisable to take up marine related courses at this juncture, sir? How safe?
Hello, sir.
I would not see, like, see, ultimately the world will win over Corona. The vaccination is being developed. It's just a matter of question whether it will take 1 year or 2 years for the vaccine. So generally, vaccines take a lot of time.
Hello.
The standard time for a vaccine is about 2 to 3 years. So I think let's be hopeful. All that I can see after Corona is people who were able to develop multiple skills are surviving. Like, please don't learn one skill and use the same skill to get money. Try to have multiple skills. Okay, try to earn money through multiple ways. You will be in a much safer position. Do that.
So we have Aman Kumar Jaff, who is doing so long. Aman, you can shoot a question.
Yes. Hello, sir. I'm Aman Kumar, sir.
Yeah, Aman.
Sir, my question is for IT field sectors, for B.Tech in computer science or BCA with MCA is better, sir?
B.Tech in computer science is the easy way.
Yes, sir.
It's recognized more. Okay, if you see the job openings, the most of the IT job openings, the requirement is eligibility B.Tech or BE, computer science / electronics and communications / information science. So I would highly recommend, if you can pursue engineering, then first option should be engineering, not BCA or MCA.
So next we have Akhtar Hussain. Akhtar Hussain, you can ask your question.
Hello, good afternoon, sir.
Yes, sir.
So my interest is astronomy and astrophysics. So my question is, I want to know if there is any scope and what courses should I pursue to take that.
See, we have the Indian Institute of Astrophysics in Koramangala in Bangalore. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay, so they offer exclusive courses on astrophysics. Okay, so when you go and visit them, they will be able to tell you about the options available for them. But most of the people who actually enter into astrophysics or astroscience, they work with Indian Institute of Science, IISc. And they also work with national level institutes. We have a couple of national level institutes where you can enroll for your master's degree. At this moment, I would recommend you to either choose between doing an engineering in computer science or electronics versus choosing a BSc in astrophysics, because even doing an engineering degree in computer science will not stop you from pursuing your career in astronomy. Okay, But ideally, it would be to visit the Indian Institute of Astrophysics website, get the information from there, and from there you please know how the process works, because from outside all this looks very glamorous and very beautiful. From the inside story, the effort that goes in, and many of them, you know, they ask me, sir, how do I become an astronaut? You know, becoming an astronaut is one in a million. If there are 10 lakh people working in the entire industry of, you know, sending satellites and launching of satellite vehicles, there are only few, 5 or 10, who are selected to be astronauts after so much of testing. So one has to look at into being connected with the industry. And I would recommend you to visit the Indian Institute of Astrophysics and get more details from them.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, Malini madam, we have any other questions?
One of the student is trying to call by call. She's not raising the hand. Just now I heard her.
You just posed a question on her behalf. What is that?
Hello?
Yes, madam. You ask. Mm-hmm. You can ask on the behalf.
Safiya is trying to enable your video. That is, you know, she's raising hand and then from past
her.
She has not posted the question, but she is trying to say that, you know, I have raised my hand to ask one question.
So you have to put the sir. Like she has to enable the video, otherwise she cannot ask the question.
So I think
I think we have covered almost everyone, sir.
Yes.
Let's conclude. And students who want to reach out to me, I gave my number. You can always reach out. If I'm busy in a webinar like this or busy with playing with my kids, I will not be available. Okay. So you can reach out and anytime if you have any queries.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, Safiya has come now. Yes, Safiya.
Yes, good afternoon, sir. Sir, actually, I'm interested in medicine, but I've kept engineering as my second option. Mm-hmm. So I'm just confused between choosing both, any one of them. Can you just advise me which one should I take?
Thank you, Safiya. This is something which thousands of students in India do.
Hello?
They say, I will become a doctor. I want to become a doctor. But if I don't become a doctor, I will become an engineer. Let's stop this. Safiya. Be very clear.
Yes.
If you want to become a doctor, you have to get a rank in NEET, which will help you to get a seat as per the finances you have, right? You may get a government seat, which will be around 1 lakh rupees, or you may get a private seat, which will be around 35 lakhs, right? If you don't get a medical seat and you still feel I should do medicine only and I will put all my effort, take a year back, appear for NEET. I have seen many success stories of people appearing for NEET. Otherwise, if you feel that I am trying to chase something which I will never touch, I am doing it out of compulsion of my parents. I am doing it out of my compulsion that I should become a doctor because I've always dreamt of becoming a doctor. Okay, dreaming is one nice thing. But if you don't set the goals to achieve those dreams and don't work hard, your dreams don't get realized. If you realize that, okay, I now feel that I do not have the ability and I'm perfectly fine with that. I am happy. I don't have the capacity to solve NEET. That should be the feeling. The emotion of every incapability should be like, God has made me good in something else, so I am bad here. Let me put it to all students here, because psychology works a lot during career success or failure. Tell yourself, maybe I was good for something great. That is why God didn't make me a doctor. Now, if you take a decision like that, and then if you look at engineering as an option, and if you know that pursuing engineering will give you a lot of opportunities, you are convinced with that, and you also have worked hard to get into a good engineering college, then pursue engineering. Because let us not say, mujhe ye nahi mila isliye main ye liya. No, mujhe ye chahiye tha, ye bhi chahiye tha, ye bhi chahiye tha. Mujhe jo mila, main khush hu. I am happy with all the options. Okay, this thing later, you know, in life, it should not be like so. If you're preparing for medicine, preparing for NEET, give your 100%. Give your best. When CET comes, don't ignore mathematics. Give your best. All PU students, my only advice is focus on giving your best to every entrance exam. Do not assume that I want to become... I have cases where people, you know, thought that I'm giving NEET, I should not give CET. Then they had given NEET, didn't give CET. They couldn't clear NEET and their parents were like, now I can't even... and get engineering seat because I didn't give CET. I want to have to go to management quota. So my request to you all is, please work hard on your goals, but be happy to take the alternate route, equally happy because you love it.
I think
hello.
Here we have one student by name Srivatsa has been repeatedly asking this question. What is the best degree for digital marketing and tracing? Like for digital marketing, to the best of my knowledge, there is no any specialized course other than management. Like you have to do management MBA or BBA then MBA. Or as well, you can do engineering because in engineering, you know, digital marketing, though it is not a subject, I have so many success stories from our own college who are very successful in digital marketing. There is one guy, Sarveshwar Thoke. Yes. He has started a digital marketing company by name Webforces. Now he drives an Audi, you know, Jaguar. Super rich now. And also, you know, there are engineering degrees, one course which is giving a lot of weightage and credits for the courses like NPTEL, MOOCs, SWIM, and these kind of short-term courses, where this digital marketing is a short-term course, where you can take up these courses and you can add to your credit as well. Definitely, this is one avenue, what I know from the engineering perspective. Then I think Amin sir can close it.
I think engineers have an advantage in digital marketing. The reason is, sometimes when you do digital marketing, you need to do a lot of analytics and tools, which may not come you when you do a BA or a BSc course. Most of the engineering students are exposed to a lot of technology. The environment is exposed. Even the digital marketers I know, most of them are engineers. They didn't get into placements. But digital marketing is not taught as part of a management course. It is taught by a lot of private online tutors. Like I am actually undergoing a digital marketing course because COVID has forced me to use COVID. Being a counselor, COVID has forced me to learn digital marketing because I cannot completely depend on a digital marketing agency for a long period. They can only initiate things. But for survival, like since I do a lot of freelancing and activities. So what I see is digital marketing is a person who is passionate about using internet in a meaningful, productive way. Like you don't get bored by working hard. If you have that ability, then digital marketing is a great career. If you are a geek, if you are by birth a student who can learn new things, then no degree is required for a digital marketer. But what happens is at certain stage in life, if you do not have a degree, you don't get entry into certain things. So I would recommend do engineering and along with
yes, sir. We'll take the last question, sir. It's from Pratiksha. Which course is best in BSc?
Please find out what you are good at. I'm repeating again to everybody. Do not look at what is good outside. See, I'll give you a simple example. You go to a hotel, you will not tell the person who comes to take your order, give what is good. Right? You actually go through the entire menu, you experience, you recall the taste. Last time I had this, I would love this. I would highly recommend, remember, you are such a great resource. Trust me, the people who are really enjoying in lockdown is people who know who they are. Okay, people who dependent on everything else, they are in a problem. Trust me, please guys, youngsters, I'm telling you, ensure that you discover yourself and believe that. And remember, not every dream is going to be realized in a day. I struggled 10 years to be a face of career counseling. I knew how much of struggle I had to go because I had an engineering degree and people used to laugh at me initially. Why are you doing engineering? People used to compare my revenues. By God's grace, now I have come to the same stage. I run a company by myself, done programs. So believe in yourself and know what you are good at should be the basis for your decision. But at the same time, you need to have a reality check. Please don't do anything just because something is offered.
So can you throw some light on agri, sir? How, because a lot of people are very crazy about agriculture. I don't know where this rumor or I don't know where it all started. What actually the agri people are doing after graduation? Where is the scope and how good is agriculture at this point of time?
Most of them who actually finish agriculture, they try to become scientists because they realize that as a scientist, they are paid well. See, remember, government actually has a lot of money because 70% people in India are into agriculture, and without that much of agriculture, you can't export and you can't run a, feed a country of this population. Because agriculture is also linked to export and import, right? Mostly export happens. So how do you develop export quality stuff? So the most of the agriculture engineers, they actually become scientists. They actually work with agriculture marketing companies. They work with NGOs which are into, you know, helping farmers. So the task is not necessarily going and working in the field. They don't go and work in the field. They actually design. And of course, I think as you brought it up, sir, data science has played a big role now. There are many apps which farmers use. You and I may not be aware of it. Farmers have become smarter because all farmers have got an ATM card now. They know how to operate. The industry, agriculture industry, is the largest employment industry because it's more of self-employment and people are working every day. They go and work every day. And you know, the agriculture produce that comes out is multi-seasonal. Like every month there is something else coming out. So most of the agriculture engineers, they end up becoming scientists. They end up becoming people who work with agriculture marketing companies to help streamline the whole initiative. They are also into inventions, inventing new things, inventing new sorts of fertilizers and hybrid and so many things. Today, you know, we all love gardening, and there's so much of things happening. So that is the scope, and that's the market range, market scenario.
Yes, sir. I think we have come to the end of the program. So, Malini, madam.
It's been a 3-hour good program.
Nice. Very interesting and interactive.
Yes.
I didn't expect us to go this way. Okay. Yes, madam.
Yeah, it was a very, very interesting session, sir. Like, it is not only engineering, not only medical, which are on the front line of all this, you know, professions. But you have thrown light on almost all the subjects what the students had in their mind, the pros and cons, and then the better opportunities and everything for that matter. It was a whole package, I should say that. And we are all very, very, very blessed to have you here with us. And with this, I would like to remind all the participants once again that we are going to send a link. The participant who fills this form will be able to get an e-certificate for attending this session, which is a very, very value-added certificate with a career consultant and career advisor. And so do fill the form and then return it, submit it, so that you will be able to get your e-certificate on your email ID. And
Sairam College of Engineering, I would like to cordially give out an open invitation to all the students and parents who participated in today's program to come visit Sairam College of Engineering to get to know more about us. And looking forward to meet you all in our campus, right? Mm-hmm. And with this small short note, I would like to thank once again our resource person, Amin sir, taking his time beyond the committed schedule and interacting with all our students. I think they had wonderful time and a lot of insights have been given by you. And even we got a lot of insights. It was a nice discussion, sir. And
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I would
like to add anything.
Yeah. It was a wonderful session, Amir, sir. It was very, very good interaction with all the students. I can say one of the best webinar, this one. It was a great session. You tried to cover all the points. Thank you once again on behalf of Sairam family. Thank you.
Thank you
one and all the participants also. And I request all the participants, they can leave this meeting. And HODs and coordinators.
No, sir. I will schedule a meeting and send. So let us not disturb this meeting. No? Yes. I send from my ID.
Fine, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
Great.
So it was a great session.
Wonderful time.
Wonderful time with you all. Thank you so much. Thank you, Sairam College of Engineering, and then our motivation people who are behind this, organizing this program, and bringing the best resource person to the program to make it as effective as it is. And I would like to thank all the coordinators, all the teams who have participated in this program to make it a successful one. Thank you, Principal Sir. Thank you, MR Sir. Thank you, Trustee Sir, Patel Sir, and Gajendra Sir. And also to all the dear HODs and all the coordinators who participated in this program and made it successful. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. With this, I think I'll sign off now. Thank you so much.